Okay, niggas, it's time to rock! Okay, Fleegs. We're starting our first Q&A podcast. We have Fleegs here. Fleegs is co-hosting. We have our first question from a guest here. And if you're a guest, you're just visiting our site, fluegen.io, F-L-U-G-E-N.io, and you visit our forum, /forum, you will be able to see the Q&A section on our forum, and you can just ask questions. You don't even have to be enrolled. We allow bitch-ass cowards to ask questions. We allow registered users to ask questions. We allow anybody to ask questions, critics, fans, whoever, over whatever, and we'll try to address it on this podcast. First question comes from Portion Control. It says, actually, Flugs, why don't you read the question, and I'll answer it. You'll be Portion Control, and let's see if we can answer this question. Go ahead.
All right. Portion Control says, I have a question about the idea I heard in one of the Flugen podcasts where professor said that everyone in the country should be required to spend a couple of years in the military. Apparently, that
is supposed to build... Hold on. Just a correction. I'm gonna answer you as you're reading, so that'll work out even better. Military or the police force. I'm not sure if it's and, but it could be and or the police force. I think it should be or. So you have a choice whether you're going to defend a country or defend citizens locally in the police force. I think either one is a viable option. Go ahead.
All right. Apparently, that is supposed to build maturity or something, by making people responsible for other people. I have some doubts about how much this will really change society. For example, some of the guys I know have been in the military don't seem masculine or responsible at all compared to average men.
Can you reread that? Start rereading that sentence because I can't hear what you're saying.
Hello.
Welcome, buddy boy. We're in Q&A section of the forum. We're reading our first question. We're doing our Q&A podcast. Go.
All right. Okay. Apparently, that is supposed to be maturity.
For example, some of the guys I know that have been in the military don't seem masculine. Okay.
For example, some of the guys I know that have been in the military don't seem masculine or responsible at all compared to average men. My stepdad, in particular, is unwilling to spank or control his kids, aged 11, 10, and 8, despite having been a Marine. He just repeats himself 50 times over until he has to yell angrily. Then they reluctantly do what he asks only half of the time. My first question is, how do you know that military training or law enforcement will discipline young men?
Is this guy going to answer his own question? He just says, after all, the military, like society in general, is more feminized than ever. Women are in high military positions, and there have even been efforts to put women in special forces groups. A laughable joke. This seems insane to me. Yeah, it seems insane to us too. Would you guys think that a military like this could be relied on to mature men, or would it have to grow its balls back first? I'm just not sure. Have you seen enough evidence of guys becoming responsible this way to make you so confident? Well, I'm not confident in the military in the least. But I am confident in the principle of discipline producing self-discipline. Meaning, if you have external discipline applied to you, then you will develop self-discipline. This is how self-discipline is developed. You're not born self-disciplined. You're not born knowing how to limit your food intake. You're not born knowing how to limit your behavior socially so you don't offend people, but you also attract them as well into relationships with you. You're not born knowing how to limit your own voice. I can remember people always telling me to shut up. Not shut up, but you're screaming. And I didn't realize as a kid, I didn't know how to regulate the volume of my voice. I was like, Dad, hey, what's going on? Like, I would just scream at the top of my lungs, and I had no concept of volume. People actually had to tell me I was fucking screaming or talking way too loud, and I had no concept of this, no self-concept, because I had no idea what limitation was as a child. You have to get limitation applied from you outwardly. Somebody has to restrict you, and then you realize, oh, that's what restriction is, and that's how I do it. So now I can do it to myself without the presence of those adults around me, or the society around me, or the police officers, military, whoever's in charge of enforcing restrictions. If I don't have them around me, I'm fucked. So I had to learn the hard way that restriction is necessary so that when they're not there, the adults aren't there, you are essentially replacing the adults, because at some point the adults will die off and you will become the new adults in their place. And if you don't know how to restrict yourself, you're going to end up a libtard. You're going to end up a tranny. You're going to end up giving gender reassignment surgery to a five-year-old. You're going to end up blaming Trump because he didn't get us into a nuclear war with Korea because your butt hurt. You're going to end up making conspiracy theories about Jews putting holes in your underwear. Without restriction, you're capable of so many dangerous, horrible, heinous, destructive things. Not just to society, even to yourself. I mean, how many fucking disgusting fatties do we have in society? Do you think you think when you see a 900-pound tons of fun, you think that guy or girl who looks like a walking version of Jabba the Hutt's stunt double is a person who understands how to restrict food intake? They are fucking talking to you while they're eating. They are eating nonstop. They're eating 20 meals a day. They're not eating breakfast, lunch, and dinner. They're eating everything is dinner. Everything is breakfast. Everything, every second of the day is lunch. There is no restriction. I mean, as a kid, my parents were so bad with restriction that I remember I went out. They didn't even restrict where I went on Halloween. They didn't even go with me. I just went out by myself. And I came back with a pillowcase full of candy. And of course,
you could get kidnapped in a way.
What's that?
You can get kidnapped if you go alone asking for treats.
Really? Now, thank you. We have a side commentary from Bunny Boy that is informing the public. PSA announcement. If you go out by yourself as a child, you could get kidnapped. So just a note to parents. Thank you, Bunny Boy, for sharing that stellar piece of advice. So I came back with a suitcase full of candy. And, of course, my parents, who were so good with discipline, took the candy away from me and doled it out at least one piece of candy at a day or at a time, right?
Yeah.
No. I just sat in the room. And I'm like, well, I like Rice Krispies. Those I'm eating right now. I don't like butterscotch candy. Those little round fucking faggot candies that old senior citizen fucks give you because they think they're so delicious. No, I throw those away. I throw away all the Bit of Honeys. Oh, actually, no. I don't throw away Bit of Honeys. I remember because I had no restriction.
You save them for later.
Bunny Boy has chimed in. Instead of eating the Bit of Honey, he said I saved it for later. Good guess, but no. That's not even the point of the story. Do you have any more amazing commentary you want to provide while I'm busy saying something I care about and you're busy, I don't know, masturbating to what? You want a high five, right? You want a hug in the middle of the podcast? What do you want? What do you want from me?
I want to participate, but I...
Well, then fucking participate. Don't just say, I saved it for later. Do you have a point or not? All right, okay. I'll tell you what. I'm going to say my point on this, and then I want your reaction to it. How about that? Then you can participate. All right. So there's my neighbor was a couple houses down. They were so lazy, they just put a box out full of Bit of Honey candies on the porch, and they wrote a little sign for kids who are good with self-discipline like me. It says, take one only. Because they, of course, thought, hey, this child will see a whole box full of candy with no adult around to restrict them and think, and they'll read the sign that is supposed to impose restriction with zero enforcement. Hey, take one candy and leave one for the rest of the children. What do you think I did, Duckface?
You took all of them. Took the entire
no
bag.
No way! I didn't fucking. I didn't take all of them. Stole it. I just double-fisted half the fucking box of candy. I think I left about like two or three pieces for the other children behind me. But it was like my first
yeah, the recounts.
My first one or two houses. So I already have half a suitcase full of bit of honey candies because these fucking retards put a sign out that said, "Hey, children without self-discipline. We are adults who don't know how to enforce any laws. We're adults who don't know how to enforce any discipline. And we're relying on you to become the adults and discipline yourself. So demonstrate that you have discipline by just taking one candy." I fucking took half the box. This is what happens when you have no restriction as a child. And then it translates into becoming an adult and essentially becoming a liberal. You're not really an adult in function. You're just an adult in name. You're nominally adult and you look like an adult. You can grow a beard. You're taller than a child physically, but you're not really an adult. That's just why you look around today and there are people that look like round balls, bouncing round balls, because they don't understand the concept of self-discipline, because nobody ever taught them discipline. Nobody ever applied external discipline to them. So, yes, I fully and wholeheartedly endorse the concept of discipline externally. You need a parent. And if you don't have a parent, you need the military or the police force or some form of discipline, external discipline, applied to you, because you will not apply discipline to yourself. Even after all these years and all my wisdom, I still have trouble self-disciplining myself because I have to learn the hard way. I had to become the adult in the absence of my parents, in the absence of society even. Society is the worst. I mean, you talk about the concept of discipline. Today, the bit of honey candy sign on the box is called, you look on the box today, what does it say? Hashtag me too. Hashtag don't be bad. Hashtag sexual assault is wrong. Hashtag men look but don't touch. Hashtag men look at my fucking clit showing through my yoga pants but don't get turned on. Hashtag look at my tits hanging out but don't say sexual things about them to your bro-friends. That's wrong. You know what kind of movies we grew up with? Fast Times at Ridgemont High. I couldn't believe it. When I went to rewatch it for, I was trying to pull a clip from it. And as I was watching it, I was actually shocked to find out. I didn't even realize it. Like, the main characters are two chicks. And I think they're supposed to be like 13 or 14. They're like really young. They're portrayed as really young. And they're having sex. So this is a film about like, basically like, if you were to put it in today's context, it would be a pedophile film. It would be a child porn film. Like, they're discussing sex between, like, preteens and adult guys. And it's not even portrayed in a bad way. It's almost just, like, mentioned matter-of-factly. Like, oh, we're 13, but we want to fuck. Let's go fuck this guy at the mall. It's like, it's so just blasé. But that's how you grew up. That's the type of films that adults show to children. And now these adults grew up, and now they're turning around and saying, hey, remember all those great lessons we told you about sex? We taught you about sex? Make sure you apply them in society today and behave yourself. You want us to behave ourselves? You showed us fucking movies. One of the most iconic franchises of all time is what? That most, you know, even adults of this generation or kids of this generation have seen.
Oh, Disney.
Disney, for sure. Dun 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 dun.
James Bond.
James Bond. What did James? Oh, yeah. What did the original, most iconic James Bond of all time do regularly in his movies that adults showed to children?
Oh yeah, he smacks girls and things like that. Yeah,
that's the light part. He smacks girls on the ass. Yes, there's a compilation of clips on YouTube of James Bond smacking chicks on the ass. Putting two chicks underwater in the hot tub to give them a blowjob. I mean, just lots of just, not blowjob, but he's just dunking them. He's basically just having his way with women left and right. That's the light stuff. What's the stuff he's really known for? It's almost iconic. It's like a joke. It's like a meme. You know what he always does in movies?
I don't remember him doing worse than that.
Like, yeah, in Goldfinger, when he's got the chick called Pussy Galore, Galore.
He raped Pussy Galore.
He fucking raped. According to today's standards, that's rape. When you jump on a girl and she's like, no, 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 I don't want to have sex. I don't want to kiss you. I don't want to do anything. And you just force her down and then you kiss her. And then she's like, no, no, no. And then she melts romantically after you. After she's resisting, she's like, fuck you, no, no, no. And then she's, oh, James. And then they fuck. What type of message do you think that sends to impressionable children when they see movies like James Bond, and he's forcing himself on a woman, and she's resistant at first, but then the fantasy is she just melts into his arms, and thank you for overpowering me. Thank you for not signing the consent forms that feminists want me to sign today. Thank you for just fucking me. And then later I just fall in love. Oh, James, you're so dreamy. This is the regular recurring theme in James Bond movies. And this is supposed to teach kids self-discipline where sex is concerned? I mean, look at the fucking billboards you see in society. I'm watching TV, I'm watching like Adult Swim Network, and I couldn't, I was over at a friend's house and I was watching it, and I don't really watch that regularly. And I wasn't really thinking about it until like a Carl's Jr. commercial came on or some other, like, there was like 20 different burger commercials that came on, all with burgers dripping everywhere. Now I see 5 different brands of burgers from 5 different restaurants while I'm watching Adult Swim, while I'm blazed, no less, because that's also a blazing network for blazers. And I'm seeing all these food products paraded. Am I learning self-discipline when I'm seeing mayonnaise and special sauce dripping off burgers and huge fucking towering-sized, delicious, sizzling meat in front of me at 12 and at midnight? Am I thinking, gee, let me control my appetite. Let me be a responsible citizen and not drive out to Taco Bell while I'm blazed at 1 a.m. in the morning and fucking buy half the menu.
You probably learned that from your parents too, by the way. Like, because your parents were probably like 70s. They grew up in the 70s.
Are you kidding me?
Right?
They know.
So they should have been like hippies, right? Right.
Not only was my mom a shitty cook, I remember vividly. I would get coupons to like Carl's Jr. for like a burger, a flat, like burger and 2 slices of bread. That was nutrition for me. My high school meals, one of my favorite meals, just chili cheese dogs. I mean, I still eat chili cheese dogs today. Just nitrate dogs. I mean, imagine I'm growing up, I'm playing sports, I'm living off of chili cheese dogs. Oh,
I used
not to
drink Coca-Cola at soccer practice.
Not to mention, I had a fucking soda with every meal. Thank God I learned something about what was in soda. Thank God I learned that soda was fucking sugar water. It's just a fucking, imagine just taking a bucket full of sugar, pour it in water, put some food coloring in, there's your drink. That's what I drank with every fucking meal because it was just normal. That's it. All my friends did. All my friends still do it today. I see friends with like Cokes in their hand. I love when they say, a diet Coke. I've been a diet. I'm fucking drinking sugar water. I mean, everything is just sugary crap. I could vividly remember just falling asleep and doing my homework and wondering why I just always beat myself up. I'm so tired. I'm in these smart classes for smart people, but I'm just so tired I can't do my homework. Why? I'm so lazy. I thought it was just lazy. I didn't realize when you drink a mountain of sugar, liquid sugar, you have energy while you're drinking it, but then you just fucking crash. I didn't understand that concept as a child. I just thought I was lazy. I want to do my homework, but I'm so sleepy right now. I want to stay awake in class, but I'm just so sleepy right now. I had no concept of discipline in my eating habits. Playing basketball. I fucked up both knees because I would play whether I was sick or not. I played when I had bronchitis. I played when I'm coughing up phlegm. It's just spitting it off the side of the court. I played when I was injured. I would fucking roll my ankle in the middle of the game and think it was manly just to keep going. You got a fucking injured ankle. Could be torn. Could be, I don't know, fucked up. I'm still playing. I thought it was manly. I had no concept of disciplining my own body. I had no concept of what exercise I needed to do, what was extreme. I always did sports to the extreme until I got injured. I get so many knee injuries just from playing sports without regulation, without regulating my body, without even thinking about possible consequences. The only time I realized that I was mortal is when I got my first serious knee injury. I was just like start of a game, and I just like turned my knee just to the right real quick before even anything even happened. And like, how did that happen? Maybe from playing 5 hours of basketball a day. I mean, that was my pastime. When instead of hanging out and just going someplace or going to even a club or just going out with friends or hanging out. My idea of hanging out was going to the court and playing basketball for 5 hours a day, nonstop. I had no concept of discipline. So yes, I firmly believe in the concept of discipline. Now, as far as you're talking about the military and the police force, obviously they're fucking faggot libtard PC control centers where they indoctrinate cops and military about how to behave like women. So yes, obviously they're completely useless today. I mean, you can learn some concept of discipline in the military or the police force. They still have regulations. But as far as like functional regulations for you becoming a self-disciplined adult, that's a gamble. That's a high-risk gamble. Today's police force, today's military is a fucking joke. The fact that you have women that are generals or women or authority positions is a joke. There's no way I can respect a fucking 80-pound woman screaming orders at me. It's a fucking joke. That cunt should be in the kitchen making waffles. She should be in the bedroom making blowjobs. She should be making babies. She should be working in childcare. She should be doing domestic duties. There's no way a cunt who can barely lift a rifle should be giving orders to 200-pound guys who are in charge of like tackling assailants or thugs or terrorists or whoever who they're going to be fighting in a war. I mean, if you have a 90-pound female soldier and you capture the platoon, she's not an enemy combatant. She's portable R&R. She's portable rest and recreation. She's a vagina. You found a... Congratulations, you just found a hooker. Enemy soldiers, you just found a hooker. Good for you. You just found a spoil of war. You're not going to interrogate that soldier. You're not going to just fucking worry about that soldier. You're going to be fucking that soldier. And now your own platoon has to worry about rescuing you, you cunt. So I hate more than cunts in the military or cunts in the fire department, the police department. Oh, I'm 90 pounds. I'm going to fucking save you from a burning building. I mean, you see fire department cunts? They have to look like a man. You're basically looking at a tranny. You're not looking at a regular female. You're looking at a chick who shaves her head, takes testosterone supplements, and looks stronger than you. That's not a woman. That's a woman pretending to be a man. And that's the only way she can make it into the fire department. Same with special forces. We're not talking about Angelina Jolie in the special forces, you stupid cunts. We're not talking about Jennifer Aniston. We're not talking about Gwyneth Paltrow. We're talking about Rosie O'Donnell with Arnold Schwarzenegger's body. We're talking about Roseanne Barr's face with Brad Pitt's Troy physique.
That's true. That's very bizarre.
We're not talking about women. We're talking about women who are dykes or women who are so delusional they are trying to become men. I mean, women today are taught by feminists that you should be proud of being smart like a man, even though you're not. Even though it's affirmative action intelligence, what we're really talking about. We're talking about women today who think it's fucking sexy to lift 500 pounds like a man. We're talking about women today who think it's smart, who think it's a good idea to wait till you're 38 to have kids when your eggs are all fucked up and now you're ready for genetic diseases or genetic problems to pass on to your children, Down syndrome and whatnot. We're talking about women who think it's a good idea to chop their hair off so they look like a picture of a can of the little dude on the Dutch boy paint can. We're talking about women who, I mean, this notion of idolizing and glorifying male traits as a female is retarded. If you are trying to become a man and do everything a man can do, who's going to do the job of a woman? Who's going to take care of children, stupid fuck? Who's got the womb? Let's ask that question first, the man or the woman? Well, technically, yeah. I know you hate to admit this. Technically, we have the womb. Technically, we have to have the children. Okay, then once you have the children, then who takes care of them? Well, I'm busy in my career. I'm busy becoming a woman who can do it all. That's why we have latchkey kids who don't know shit who are eating Tide Pods, you fucking retarded cunts. That's why we have kids who get molested because the mother's not there to watch them.
Yep.
That's why we have kids who get into all kinds of trouble. I mean, because obviously they don't have dads around when you got single moms running the show. But not only that, the single moms can't be everywhere at once, even though they think they can, even though feminism sells them on the idea that they can have it all. No, you can't have a career and raise your child at the same time, stupid fuck. I know you think that a child only needs an hour of attention a day, or maybe 30 minutes of attention a day. But if you let your kid be raised on the internet, not only will they speak in meme pictures and be retarded fucking pseudo-adults when they grow up, they're going to be exposed to beheading videos on 4chan. Sure. They're going to be exposed to tranny porn. They're going to be exposed to child porn. They're going to be exposed to the Pain Olympics, where dudes are putting needles through their dicks to see who's cooler.
Oh my
God. They're going to be exposed to Eurofags neo-Nazi videos praising Hitler. I mean, this new student we got, Brick. I mean, the assignment, last week's assignment was post 10 songs you like. Let's see what this fucking retard did with his songs. Unbelievable. Okay, let me go here. Go to the homework section. Let's see an example. Then we might have a retard who just figured out he might need to register on the forum before he can see the fucking link to the podcast. Before he can see the link to, it's Pretender. Fucking genius. All right. Let me get Pretender in here real quick. What group is he in? He's a freeloading scumbag. Yeah,
yes, he's a freeloading scumbag.
Yeah. Hold on a second. Okay, pausing for some administrative duties here. Boom. Admin. Boom. Activated. Boom. Congratulations, you idiot. See, he's a prime example of a guy who's not self-disciplined enough to know that I said way before this podcast started, this class was starting, hey, you need to register in the forum if you want to see the link to the Hangout so you can get in and be on the podcast. Oh, wait, why don't I do that in the middle of the podcast, in the middle of class? You fucking retard. Why don't I interrupt the guy talking and giving wisdom to the next generation so they don't have to end up with their head in the toilet? Where were we? yes.
You were speaking about the brick.
Single mothers letting the internet raise their children. Let's see the result of what happens when you let a single mother raise your child, and they're given a simple assignment like, for net homework for next week, post your top 10 songs of all time in this thread. I wanted to see what you enjoyed in life, since you're such cowards, since women raise men to become cowards and not be able to state what they like or want in a relationship. I thought I'd do a simple passive assignment that addressed that notion so I could see what they dwelled on or what type of music moved them and what type of music affected them, what they gravitated towards, what types of problematic songs they listened to alleviate the pain and strife in their life, and what types of songs they listened to inspire them, to make them want to keep living. Let's see what we got from Fuckface over here. This is also the reason why I hate pseudo-intellectual faggots like this guy. Let's see here. What do we got? Okay. A lot of people did this assignment. Then we come to this guy who wanted to be edgy. This is what the generation of children in this age are known for, being edgy. I'm shocking. I'm not allowed to say 80% of these lyrics. Oh, I wonder why. Let me check. Let's see what this song is. This is on his iPod probably, right? Let's see what's on his iPod. Yeah, motherfucker.
What's up, nigga?
Oh, you're so edgy. You said the word nigga 5,000 times. So you think I'm going to listen to a song that's 2 minutes and 57 seconds long of some fucking retarded nigga just saying nigga because of the meme, because it's funny? This is what you actually seriously listen to and enjoy? No, stupid. You know what this is? This is a sad, pathetic attempt by a pseudo-intellectual to appear smart and to try to impress me by posting a funny song. You listen to guys who say nigger. I've never heard the word nigger before. That's so shocking. That's so edgy. I'm so impressed. Now we're best buddies because you posted a song that says nigger. Now I know you have edgy humor. We're friends, right? Wrong, idiot! You can't even follow the fucking directions. I'm disgusted. I'm disgusted because I knew if I ask you, and I will ask you whenever you show up to class, Brick, I'm going to ask you to go through your whole list. I'm going to teach you how to discipline yourself, even through your funny jokes. Because I know you're going to go through your whole list and go, oh, shit. I didn't think somebody would hold me accountable to my choices. That's why I posted this stupid nigga song in the first place. I thought you were stupid like the other adults in my life. I thought you were retarded enough like the teachers that taught me in class to give me an assignment and not bother to check to see if I did it correctly. No, dumb fuck. I'm the worst teacher you ever met. I'm going to teach you how to be competent.
You're a teacher.
I'm super teacher. I'm going to teach you how to be an adult. I'm going to go through each of these songs one by one. I'm going to hold you accountable to all your funny jokes, all your shocking humor. I can't wait. I was actually rubbing my fingers in glee. Once I went through these songs, I was disgusted. But then I started rubbing my fingers in glee because I knew in the middle of class, in front of all your peers, I was going to hold you accountable to these songs and make you fucking explain every fucking one of them. I got a hard on. I went from having no dick, my dick turned inward at the stupidity of you thinking you were smart posting these songs, to getting a full massive nigger boner because I knew you were going to fold like a little silly bitch and have to realize, oh, wait a second. Maybe the assignment wasn't to see how edgy and funny I could be by posting weird shit. Maybe that wasn't the point. Oh, wait a second. We have one of those children in class right now. Guess who I have a boner over right now?
Me?
Me. The person even knows who they are. Notice how the other people didn't say me? But the guilty party already knows how stupid they are? Let's go through his song choices.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah. Yeah, you're a fag. Yeah, you're up. Yeah.
Hitler fan.
Hitler, Seven Nation Army. Mm-hmm. All right, let's check it out. Here we go. Does this video even pop up?
I hope so.
Is it the actual song Seven Nation Army, or is it some Hitler version of it?
No, it's a Hitler version.
Nation, oh, what? Army, Hitler.
It's the same melody, but you have video clips from Hitler.
Why is this? We're yeah. posting videos that don't even show up. Here we go. Okay, at least they found it on Hitler. I'm surprised they haven't censored it yet.
They show up to me.
The following content has been identified by YouTube faggots as inappropriate or offensive to some audiences. I understand and wish to proceed. I understand that I may be shocked to know that people like Hitler exist in society. Oh my gosh! I'm going to push the consent button. Oh my god. Oh, here we go. We see a Nazi flag being raised. Oh my gosh. We see Nazi soldiers. The Reich the Gestapo.
That's bad. That is bad news.
We hear old clips of Hitler talking about they don't get the time to say so far. We see the pussy in the saloon. Down.
All right, great. Okay, so we know you're masturbating to Hitler. Got that one.
Yeah.
All right. Adolf Hitler believer. Here we go. Next one.
Oh, yeah, this.
Wait a second. Is this an actual white power song with white power lyrics, or do you just take regular pop songs and put the silly Hitler imagery behind them and make them edgy and intense?
I just find him, and what I like, I'm like, fuck yeah, I'll pick him.
I know you might be on the slow bus, but let me repeat the question. Do you just find regular pop songs, aka non-Hitler songs, and then put Hitler imagery in the background like a video, like a YouTube video, and then post like those? Is that what this song is, or is it an actual Hitler song that was crafted by the Third Reich?
No, it's not crafted by the Third Reich. It's the pop songs, and they...
It's edgy. All right, we got the point. All right, fuck this one. This is silly, too. All right, do you have anything that's not like... Okay, here we go. You said I was a dreamer. Here we go. Is this what the same thing, too? We got a pop song and a Hitler imagery?
No, I don't know what this is, but it's really fucking... It touches me every time when I watch it.
It touches you because you see the Third Reich imagery?
No, because of what this... It's a long
how
story.
Could you not? How could you not be affected by the slow motion Nazi flag waving in the wind while this song is playing and you're watching the video? And you're associating all the Hitler imagery, all the Third Reich Nazi imagery, with a song.
I don't give a fuck about the flag. The thing is that I didn't like express why I'm fascinated with this, and that's why you
I know why you're like, fascinated. You have, it says Hitler imagery. The first three videos you posted all have the same Hitler imagery. It's, I've seen it on trillions of videos where they just show montages of soldiers marching, black and white videos, Hitler talking in that McDonald's, you know, drive-thru window box voice. All the Sieg Heils. What's not to get about this?
Well, like, this is like, this, I got into this recently because...
You recently became a neo-Nazi?
Yeah, like a year ago or something like that.
Great. All right.
So, like, maybe you, because you might gorilla, but not me. And I,
hey, what? Because I gorilla? What?
What?
You said gorilla?
No.
Well, stop muttering. Open your mouth. Enunciate.
Okay. Maybe because you are older and you got you know all this shit about on the internet. Maybe that's why you saw all this. But like for me, this is new shit. So whenever I see them and like I like.
You've never seen a Hitler montage video before?
No, I didn't. I mean, the internet is so fucking censored, and what do you expect me to say? Yeah?
I expect you to say yeah. I don't know what, maybe the censorship is rampant in your country, but here it's like, they share it like it's casual. I mean, I have Apu, who's a fucking Paki terrorist, sharing, he's not literally a terrorist, but we call him a terrorist, you know, in a jesting familiar way, but he's posting Hitler, memes or Hitler stickers.
There's sticker packs Telegram.
On Telegram with Hitler saluting and heiling and whatever. I mean, that's how ubiquitous Hitler meme culture is. I'm surprised you haven't come across it. That's why I'm actually shocked that you're like, oh, this is the first time in this year you've come across Hitler imagery.
Yeah, and not only that, but like I don't listen to many songs. And so when you say like put the top 10 songs, I was like, oh fuck, like I don't give a fuck about the songs. But I'll just go after like what
are you like me when I was a kid? Like I didn't understand the concept of music. I thought music was just for certain people. Like my brother listened to music or my mom listened to music, and I was just like, oh, that's interesting. But I don't really care too much. I could go without music. Like I just thought music was like a little niche genre of life. Like you like Legos or something, or you like kitty porn.
No, it's not like that, but like most of the music.
I was gonna say kitty porn, but I actually meant kitty porn. Like you watch some weird niche of experience, and I thought, oh, that's exactly what music is. When I was a kid growing up, I was like, oh, my brother listens to K rock. That's just his niche thing. So I'll listen to it when he's listening to it, but I don't care about music. It's music. Yeah. What do I do with music? It's just a thing. Because I was into sports and stuff, you know, playing with friends, riding bikes, and playing whatever sport they were playing. I didn't really think of music too much. So I kind of understand it. Now, later in life, I've come to appreciate music, and I like music. I usually listen to it daily, but I never even had an appreciation for it when I was a kid.
Yeah, like, whenever I listen to music, it bores me. It's not that it bores me, but it's, like, tedious. It's, like, this fucking weird song. Like, whenever I play video games and I put songs, like, after a while, like, I listen.
Are you talking about like
week?
Music with like a song, like a dude singing lyrics and stuff? Or are you talking about like background music? Like a lot of dudes today listen to background like ambient noise type music where it creates a mood like don like Pretender. He listens to ambient like Viking type music when he's playing games, so he's immersed by the music in this kind of world of I'm a superhero. It's not like lyrics which will actually distract you and jar you out of that world. It's like the immersive background music is supposed to put you into a world. Like if you're blazed, you might necessarily not want to hear lyrics. You might just want to hear sounds, so you kind of like escape, like you're floating away.
Yeah, I listen to both. I just made the compilations. I put them on Winamp. I open Winamp and I play. Whatever like goes in there, I just listen to them. But like after a week, it's like so fucking tedious, and I don't want to listen to it anymore. So that's why like I had to put the video clips that I listen to the most. And the first one is like in those orders. And
is it tedious because you listen to the same songs over and over and over? Or is it tedious because you're listening to the same artist over and over and over? Because music to me has like so many different genres and... Oops. All right, we're back. We just took a potty break. As I was saying, music to me has so many different genres that it's weird that you could be call something tedious when there's so many different types of music. You're a fag.
Yeah, well, whenever I listen to you putting like slow music, I'm like thinking, yeah, I want to enjoy it, but like something in me is like fuck that, like I don't.
You're into the, more. Like, listen, there a lot of dudes are posting like, what the fuck? I even saw some dude post Megadeth on there, or Rage Against the Machine. They're posting like hardcore that hardcore anger music that mirrors their anger inside. When you don't have control over your life, you're very angry about things. So you naturally want that, like, impatient, angry music. So I am sure you would more respond to, like, let's see, who has... Even, Flukes, do you have any angry music on there?
Yeah, for sure, for sure.
For sure, he's like, for sure, for sure. See, the funny thing is, this is how you could tell. This is how you could tell you guys are liars. Because this is the common theme. Guy like me talking, intense, you'd think I should have the angry da-da-da-da-da music. But I have the emo fag music. But dudes who are quiet like Bunny Boy and Duckface, they're the guys who have the intense music. That's how you can tell they're liars in class. Let's check out what they posted. Give me an example.
I can share it.
Go ahead.
I'm not into aggressive music anymore. I used to.
Anymore.
I'll share my screen here.
Since he posted it for homework this week, not anymore.
Can you see it?
Go ahead.
Yes.
Just pick one.
I only had two hardcore songs, actually.
Just pick one.
The other ones are kind of soft.
Just pick one. Just skip to the middle so we start raging.
Yeah.
So, you don't need to share it. You can just play it.
It's not super hard. It's not like Megadeth or something like that.
All right. Does anybody have any hard songs on their fucking list here?
I have Megadeth and Death. That's a really
all right. Let's go. Song. Let's go to yours. Where is it?
I can share the screen if the duck face.
You don't need to share it. Just fucking play it. I don't care about the fucking thing. Just play it.
Okay. I'll share the audio.
Just skip to the middle. Okay, forget it. Alright, I can't. I love when I try to find an example and find some cooperation.
Here it is.
Yeah! I heard a scream. There we go. From the very eyes, every glance is out of this game. The end will be nigh. You're sure than mine. Seek Kyle! Alright, you can stop it.
I'm trying to stop it, okay.
Alright, yeah.
This was my favorite band for the longest time.
Yeah, this is the type of stuff that me and my friends, like, when we're out camping, we fucking make fun of, like, we'll dance around the campfire, and we'll be like, Seek Kyle! We'll pretend we're on a mosh pit and be like, fucking Seek Kyle can play this type of music. But, yeah, this is more reflective. I would think this would be something more to your liking, Eurofag. Seek Kyle!
Dude, it still pisses me off. Like, Bunny Boy's music, if I don't hear the lyrics, I'm like, fuck it, like, I don't care. So what I do is, like, I put in there, like, Evanescence, where, like, she sings and, like, she draws, like, the song. And, like, she has this fucking passion in the voice, in her words, and Evanescence.
Evanescence?
I don't fucking know how to pronounce it.
How do you pronounce it, Pretender? Pretender, how do you pronounce it?
I think it's Evanescence.
Evanescence?
Yeah, she's like, one of those things on, wake me up inside!
Yeah.
Wake me up inside. I don't know. We're gonna come and down. Save me.
Yeah. It's the girl that sings opera with the metal music in the background.
Gotcha. Yeah. Okay. So he likes metal opera.
Metal opera.
He likes the intensity of metal opera.
Well.
Okay, well, it makes sense. Intense music speaking for you. You guys with the intense music, you remind me of the the chicks who hand you a CD and say, here's my feelings by through other artists. I'm too shy to tell you how I think about you. Here's the CD compilation. Just the intellectual I wanted to see.
Brick.
All right, Brick. Let's go over your homework. Whee!
4D Chess. The 4D Chess Master is back.
Oh, yeah. 4D Chess Master. Back in action. All right, 4D Chess. Let's see. Where's your amazing stuff here, Eurofag? Ah, here we go. Okay, first song. The first song. The song you listen to. Song in your iPod, right? Song in your car. Your favorite song. Let's go to the middle of this. So much chicken. Nigga. Why would you naked in my kitchen? Nigga. Why you call them hoes bitches? So shocking. I'm catching the vapors from your hardcore song lyrics. Okay, why did you choose this one? Why is your favorite one? Why do you listen to it so often?
Well, it's an example of how... I can say it's an example of expression that, like, really drives forward how...
I can't understand. You're going to have to enunciate your words a little more.
Yeah, okay.
Breck, you can really put that thing away from your mouth. You can, spit that thing that you have in your mouth. Because if you listen to a podcast, you really cannot tell that it's your voice. For example, when I listen to my voice, there's no way I can recognize myself. So how about you save up the trouble and get that thing out of your mouth so we can actually understand what you're saying?
No, actually, but the thing about it is it often helps enunciate because it reminds me that I have to kind of overdo it and speak really clearly.
Wait, hang on a second. You're putting something physical in your... Dude, get that shit out of your mouth and just say what you have to say.
He works in the government, so he's got some hardcore job, so he doesn't want to risk losing his occupation. So it's fine. Go ahead.
Okay,
go ahead. Tell us again.
Well, I really like the song because it...
Can you look up here? Why are you looking at your shoes? Look here.
What?
Look here so we could see you. Like, we're having a conversation. You're looking down at your shoes. Stop looking at your shoes. Just look here.
Yeah, it pokes fun at censorship. It's just a really perfect a demonstration of the ridiculousness of having the forbidden words.
Very hardcore intellectual point. All right, you even sound like you're in a library lecturing on this song. Okay, let's go to the next one.
That's pretty much it.
All right, I knew I was not the only. So this is your favorite song, of course, right? You listen to this all the time, or you're just here to teach me and make intellectual points with all these. All right, we'll find out. Okay, let's go to the next. I got it. Let's go to the next one. We Like Bukkake. It looks like the title of this one. Some weird furry thing. Looks like half a fish. Looks like a 4chan-derived song. It doesn't even play. Is there a version of this song that plays? I Like Bukkake. I'm scared to look this up, right? Look up this alternative version. Okay, we got the HD version of it. Here we go.
I like Bukkake. I like Bukkake. I like Bukkake. I like Bukkake. I like Bukkake.
Alright, I can't even tell what it is. It looks like a weird demon puppet singing I Like Bukkake. It seems like you like repetitive words.
I like Bukkake, I'm a donkey for your love. I like it funky, you like it funky. I like
Okay, why is this your favorite song?
I like things that break taboos and expresses things about people that is usually considered inappropriate.
I don't understand something here. Well, I do understand something, but I want to get it out of you. Because you're speaking about, like, you're giving a dissertation in MIT about this song when we both know you're just the fucking faggot trying to be edgy. So why are you fucking insulting my intelligence? But, well, I like to break social norms with the advanced, integration into society as we see the political culture grow more intense. And blah, blah. Why are you jerking me around? This is like 4chan faggot shit.
So what the hell am I supposed to do?
To tell me what you're actually thinking, not jerking me around. What do you think? I'm this stupid? I mean, you're an insult to my intelligence. I'm a bright guy. You're a bright guy. You're jerking me around like I'm stupid. Well, how am I supposed to trust you and want to form a relationship with you? Exactly what you're here for, by the way. What you're paying $200 to be here for. And you're lying to me and telling me I'm too stupid to figure out that you're being edgy.
Well, I am being edgy. I like being edgy. I mean, that's...
You make it sound like it's like this is how you actually are. I am edgy, and this is how I behave in society. That's not even how you talk! In your head! In your head, like, hey, you're giggling like a faggot! So why are you pretending like you're an academic?
Why do you do these pauses, man? Like you're some...
We already know. Shut up! If you're gonna interrupt... Don't ask a fucking faggot passive-aggressive question, you old fag. Give him your actual opinion. Give him some actual criticism that can help him. Say, why are you doing this? We already know why he's doing it. And the fact that you're asking him why he's doing it shows that you're just as dishonest as him.
Yeah, Brick, whenever you pause, I think of you like you're retarded. Like, you cannot answer, like, fast enough. Not fast enough, but, like, you basically forge a lie in your head. So I'm like, nigga, just fucking get to the fucking straight answers, because... Like, all this fucking waiting is, like, getting me on edge. I'm, like, thinking, is this guy, like, actually retarded, or is he a 4D chess master?
I already told you. I got it off my mind. I mean...
You're a fag. That was a terrible correction. Brick, here.
Thank you, pretender, for not letting the standard go into the toilet.
Dude, Brick, The problem is, like, if you want to be edgy, fine. I don't really care if you're edgy. I just hate that in your head you're like this defiant guy that's like, fuck society, fuck their opinion, I like music that's going to piss you off. But then when you speak, it's like, hey, bro, here's my tongue.
Yeah, that is exactly, like, that's towing the party line. You're talking about being edgy, but you're only edgy in your head. It only counts if you're edgy out loud.
I want you to be edgy out loud. Like, I want to, like, the emotion that you feel when you're listening to this music and that you're kind of feeling a release for, I want to hear that through your mouth. I don't want to hear, like, edgy music and then super, like you said, toe the party line, I follow the rules. What? That's not what I hear when I hear this music. I hear break all the rules. But then when I see you, I'm like, government official. Probably works for, like, the whatever country version you're in of the CIA or some shit. That's why you gotta hide behind, like, a fake voice.
Well, that's how I feel just listening to it. I don't see how that's
That's not
enough.
How you feel. Like, you want me to believe that a puppet singing about I love Bukkake like this, which is all silly and wacky, and you aren't talking about it like
silly.
This.
I like silly stuff like that.
And you are talking about it like
it makes
this.
Me giggle, just...
You are talking about it in a remote third party way, as if this is how you actually talk and think about things. Stop lying to me! What do you want me to do? How can I help you? How can I teach you how to socialize? How can I teach you how to attract other people to want to engage with you and want to hang around you if you're going to lie to me blatantly and you know you're lying? I know you're lying. Who doesn't know you're lying at this point? I mean, maybe out in society they actually think you're an intellectual guy who actually talks like that. But here, we know better. The cat's already out of the bag, so why are you still pretending?
It's hard not to pretend.
Oh, okay. It's hard not to pretend. So you want me to just... You're essentially wearing a Halloween costume in class and saying, I am Dracula. And you want me to buy that. I mean, that's essentially what you're doing. You're saying, I'm Dracula. And I'm just supposed to fold reality around you. I'm just supposed to pretend I'm stupid and go, oh, I guess we have Count Dracula here. I mean, you know what you want to say. You already know what you believe. You already know what you think of society. I mean, this stuff is probably all from 4chan. You already think society's trash. Guess what? I think society's trash too. That's why we even have to have this class in the first place. The only difference is I'm letting you know what I think. You're still playing poker and pretending like, well, I'm an intellectual, I'm part of society, blah, blah, blah. But really, you're like, fuck society. Here's the stuff I actually respond to. Here's the stuff I think is reflective of my real views of society. Hello?
Yeah. I mean, it does. You can say I don't care about society.
You don't know? I think he pinned you down perfectly. Like, what he said, it's like, I wish I could say that, or I wish I do say that. I would say that, because that's exactly what I think. That's why I listen to some of the music I listen to.
You think I'm dumb enough to think that you're a stuttering faggot in your head? You really think that you talk like this in your head? Oh, well, yeah, that's how I talk in society. You think that's really what I think is going on in your head? You think I'm that dumb, I'm that gullible, and I really think you sound like that in your head. Is that what you want me to believe? Because if you really, really want me to believe that, the problem is, the consequence of that is, you are boring as fuck, and I don't want anything to do with you. So, if you really want me to believe this lie you're trying to sell me, it's really, I mean, you can do it and get away with it, but what are you really getting away with? Because at the end of the day, I'm like, okay, you're a boring, faggot, pseudo-intellectual pretending to be smart in this academic voice. Great, I don't care. I don't care about you. I don't want to talk to you. So what are you accomplishing by pretending with me? What are you accomplishing by pretending with a class? You really think the class from the education they've received here want to end up taking the skills they have to relate to people and use them to form a relationship with a guy who's like, well, yeah, I like OJ thinks. Yeah. You really think after all the hard work they put in, all the sacrifice to learn how to get out of their fucking shell, they want to end up talking to a guy like you?
Look, I am going to be bad at this. I knew coming in I was
I understand you're bad at it. Thank you for sparing my feelings and telling me you're going to be bad at this. I don't care. I expect you to be bad at this. I expect you to make mistakes. I am not expecting you to continue lying to me when I know you're lying, you know you're lying, the class knows you're lying. So knock it off. You should be thankful that this place exists, because if this place didn't exist, your lying would be justified. That's what society wants you to do. That's the pressure you feel when you're outside of this class. That's what you should do. I would think you're weird if you weren't lying outside of this class. But at least we have our own, quote, safe space here where you can be yourself, where you can give your real thoughts, where you can be a person who people are like, aha, that guy's an actual intellectual. He has actual thoughts about society that I agree with or disagree with, but at least they're stimulating because he tells me what his actual belief is, not some fucking bizarre socialized version of his belief. Some boring, asexual, no personality version of his belief. Give me your belief.
Well, whatever. Look, I didn't know how exactly we were going
to
go into
this. I don't know what we're going to look at. Is this how you want to talk to me? Is this how you want to sound when you're talking to your... Think about how you want to talk to your friends. Do you really want me as a friend, if you were going to form a relationship with me as a stranger, do you want me to go... Would you meet me and be gravitating towards the guy, hello, yeah, we have the same views about this. Yes, I also like that music. This music, yeah. Yes, I also like that meme. That was very edgy, and it was quite humorous. Is that how you want me to talk back to you? You don't know. You can't figure it out.
No, I don't want.
Okay, so if you don't want that, why are you giving? Why are you giving me something? Why are you giving me something you don't want yourself? That's like saying, here's a bowl of shit for dinner. Would you eat the bowl of shit? Hello? Would you eat the bowl of shit?
No.
Then why do you want me to eat the bowl of shit? What makes you think I want to eat the bowl of shit?
Okay, here's the thing.
Answer the question. He's asking you a straight question. Answer his straight question. That's how you start not lying. You answer direct questions.
You gave me a bowl of shit.
I want to try to serve you something else.
Well, okay. Well, you are still serving me shit. What do you want me to do with the shit? Eat it? Do you want to eat this shit? Do you want to talk? You want me to talk like this for the rest of class? Will this inspire you to socialize if I talk like this for the rest of class? What if I just, your $200 went to me talking like this? Hey, guess what? You need to say what you believe so that people will know what you're talking about. Then also you need to say why you believe things so that you will be able to relate to people's necessities. And then you need to commit to your belief so that others will want to follow you and be motivated to give you what you need. Will this inspire you to keep talking to me and keep attending classes? Huh?
No.
Will you think your money is well spent if I continue to teach you how to act like you already know how to act?
Nope.
Okay, then why are we fucking doing that? Let's knock that shit off. We're trying to get away from that shit. Tell me your actual views about your stuff you posted. Tell me a view about the Bukkake song. Go ahead.
The thing is, you're trying to lead me, and I am playing 4D chess,
and I know I'm wise to these ways, so I know better. Blah, blah, blah. Okay, so we're back to you feeding me a bowl of shit. I guess then I should feed you a bowl of shit since this is what you want, right? You want to give me a bowl of shit, and you expect a bowl of shit back in return? Okay, I am sorry I tried to catch you intellectually and I tried to outsmart you. I do not mean to outwit you. I want to talk the way you want to talk to me. Is this much better now? Have we bridged the gap now? Are we socially competent now? Now that we know what each other are doing, we are playing chess. Oh, I don't want to outsmart you. I don't want to look stupid in class. I'm glad that you caught the contingency plan.
Brick.
Should we have long pauses so that we can all calculate? We can recalculate? That chess piece went there. Oh, shit. This is fucking speed chess. Fucking make your move.
The thing is,
what is the thing? Tell me the thing now so I can calculate for my next move too. Go ahead.
You're leading me.
Oh, I am leading you. Then why don't you lead yourself, stupid ass? Don't you have your own beliefs? Can you lead yourself then?
Each of us?
Why are you speaking for them, dickface? You have your own beliefs. You're talking about you leading me when you're trying to lead the class. Each of us? You're trying to lead them, you dishonest fuck! How do you have the nerve to lecture me about leading you when you're doing the exact same thing?
Look, I don't know how to be led by you.
You don't know how to answer a question, in other words. You don't know how to give your belief. You're essentially telling me, I don't know what I believe about what I posted. I have no idea why I posted it. It just magically happened. I magically hit that button. I magically selected that song. Out of all the fucking possible videos on the internet, I magically just accidentally hit those bizarre videos.
No, I pick them because that's what I think about.
Oh, that's what I think about. Oh, I didn't realize that's what you think about. I did not realize that's what you think about. I guess this is what I think about too. So what do you want me to do now? Now that I know what you think about, and now that you know how I talk and think about things, what would you like us to do? How can we move forward now? What would you like me to do? I mean, you insist on giving me a bowl of shit and trying to sell me on the idea that you sound like this in your head, and you're trying to sell me on the idea that it's normal to pause for 20 seconds after a friend asks you a question or talks to you or wants a response from you, and you think, oh, well, the normal response is to wait and calculate. How much fun do you have? How much fun are you at parties? Or I ask you something, we're talking about something, you're like, hold on, let me pause for 20 seconds for station identification while I come up with a reply and calculate. Make sure you're not trying to get one over on me. You really think my goal here is to embarrass you and look good in front of internet strangers? You think that's my goal?
I don't think you care about that.
I think you do care about that, because you're trying to lead me. Lead yourself. I'm asking you. I want to hear your belief. I don't want the regurgitated pseudo-academic version of this belief. I don't want that.
Like, you asked for the top 10 songs, the top 10 favorite songs of my life. I don't think about songs like...
Okay, forget about the songs. I don't care about the assignment anymore. I care about what you posted. Let's talk about what you posted and why you posted it. You don't know. You're still calculating. See, you think the way to form a relationship is just to outsmart me. Okay, number one, you won't outsmart me because I teach socializing. I already know what you're doing, stupid. Okay, number two... Even if you do outsmart me, and I'm just dumb enough, I'm gold enough. Okay, let's say I am dumb enough. Let's say you do outcalculate me, right? Okay. How do I calculate you?
You're calculating
right now, you fucking faggot. Whenever you pause for 20 seconds, we already know what you're doing. We teach that here. Okay. So now that you've outcalculated me and you know the correct response, what will that get you? What will that get you? If I believe your lie, that it's this is just how you normally speak, and you just normally calculate. Okay. If I buy it, what is the consequence? What do you think is the
end? That's what I was about to ask you. How can I outsmart you?
You're trying to right now, but I don't know all the calculation. You're trying to outsmart the class. You actually are trying to sell the class that this is
okay,
how
you
communicate.
If you can tell me what I'm trying to do, can you tell me how it can possibly finish?
What do you mean how you can possibly finish?
You're already telling me what I'm trying to do. Can you tell me what is the end result? How is it going to end?
I'll tell you the end result. Go ahead, buddy boy.
I think you're lying. I think you're covering your ass. I think you're bullshitting. I think you're wasting my time. And the only reason I'm not interrupting is because I cock blocked before and I'm silent. But other than that, I think you're a fucking retard. That's what I think about
you. So there's your end result. So your end result is you are alienating people. You're trying to learn. You're coming to a place to learn how to socialize and form relationships with people so people want to hang out with you and want to give you the resources you need. And you are doing just the opposite. That is the result of all your make-believe. All your pretending is, I don't want to do it. This guy over here just told you. He doesn't want to interrupt. He's a nervous fag. He doesn't want to interrupt. But he's told you. He doesn't want anything to do with you. Okay, so that's what the net result of you pretending is nobody wants anything to do with you. In real life, that translates into, you're just a weird guy and I want to ignore you. I wouldn't talk to you. That's what the real...
Now, is that true whether or not I could outsmart you? Let's say I'm some...
Okay, let's say you outsmart me. Okay, but how would I know? Because you're lying to me, and I'm too dumb to know it, how would I even know you're outsmarting me? All I know is my experience of you. Boring, monotone guy, saying nothing. Why would I even care about you if you even outsmarted me? Number one, I wouldn't know. And number two, I just wouldn't care. I would just know there's a boring, monotone faggot in front of me. I just wouldn't want to talk to you. That's it.
Rick, every time you're trying to sell me your fake voice, you're trying to sell me a fake personality that I know isn't you. That's you trying to outsmart me. I know that this isn't what you really think about things. You don't sound like this. That's what makes me mad, because guys like you actually have the most vivid imaginations and create the most beautiful pieces of art and create video games and create things that are actually very, very moving. But then you hear them in interviews and shit, like developers. They're the most boring assholes that you're talking about. But they create these wonderful, beautiful games. It's like... Who the fuck? What the fuck? If these guys learned to speak, they would be the most interesting guys.
I know. I instantly know you're a liar because all your videos are the most bizarre fucking like 4chan-ish meme-y type shit on the internet. And if I was to go like, if I was to imagine the person who created them, I would just imagine like this punk kid with like pink hair and like listen to tunes and like a hacker, you know, from the movies, like some Chinese weird kid, into Jap culture, whatever. That's who I think. Instead, I get Mr. Academic with glasses. Just I'm just a normal guy. Huh? It's just a lie. And you're trying to pretend like I'm too stupid to figure it out. You're trying to pretend like the class is too stupid to figure out. This is what we teach here.
See, you're trying to outsmart me right now. That's why you're pausing. You're trying to think how. You're trying to think. This is what you're doing. You're like, here's my view. This is my response. And then you try to put it through this editing system that you think I will like. Like, how can I say what I think in a way that Pretender, Bunny Boy, and Hi There will like?
Oh, okay. But by the way, he can't just say what he likes. He also has to answer the criticism so he doesn't look stupid. He's also going to have to make coherent points. And I also have to cover my ass with a lie. So you have this whole complex network of communication contingency plans you got to answer for right now. And that's why you're overheating, because it's impossible to keep lying when we already have lie detector processes in place to figure out if you're lying or not.
No, look, I don't like things about myself, and I don't know how to destroy them, and I'm trying to make myself
vulnerable. You don't need to know. Listen, you don't need to train in your head. You don't need to know how to destroy them. All you have to do is just answer things at face value here, and we will get you there. You are worried about making a mistake when this class is designed for you to make mistakes and then be adjusted accordingly. You can't even go forward without making mistakes. You're trying to tiptoe through a minefield without blowing up. You will blow up. I mean, you've already blown up. You posted weird fucking videos, and now you're trying to act like an academic wall. You have these weird fucking videos. It's already a mistake. It's already blown up. Your leg is already missing. You're acting like you're fine. Hey, I'm fine, guys. You're fucking leaking blood out of your face. Is turning white. You're almost dead. You've already fucked up. You think you haven't fucked up. So continue to fuck up and let us adjust you so that you will be confident in your own skin. You'll be comfortable in your own skin. Let's go.
Stop. Okay, what are we doing?
Listen, see, we already know you're a liar because remember in your scholarship interview, you're the guy who thought so highly of yourself. I love public scrutiny. It's my favorite thing. You're a lie. You lie to yourself. You hate scrutiny. You don't want scrutiny from anybody. This is what scrutiny feels like. You're afraid to death of scrutiny. You know, I know this. I'm afraid to death of scrutiny. But once I got it, I realized, I know how to deal with it now because I've gotten it and answered it. Now I can be comfortable in my skin because I understand what the purpose of scrutiny is for. See, when somebody criticizes me, I can do one of like three things. I can go, why are you being mean to me? I can go, why am I such a bad person? I could go, or I could say, is the criticism valid? So I have to find out why they're criticizing me. See, once I say, why are you criticizing me? I put the burden on the critic. And that's why people are afraid of me now, because I'm not afraid to criticize the critic. I'm not afraid to make the critic accountable. You see, criticism is designed to make you accountable. It's saying you're fucking up. You need to be accountable for what you're doing or what you're saying. Your job, you're fucking up. I'm criticizing you. You're not accountable to your job. You're speaking about something that's wrong or bad or off or offensive. I'm criticizing you because you're not accountable to what you're saying. But similarly, I've learned that criticism works both ways. Criticism is like a double-edged sword. Criticism also says something about the critic. Because if I just tell you, hey, you're a faggot, your response can be, fuck you. Your response can be, why are you being so mean? Or your response can be, an accountable response, why are you calling me a faggot? See, that's a scary question to a critic. Because I can call you a faggot, I can make a claim about you, I can make an accusation about you. But being a critic also means I have to be accountable to my accusation. That means I have to say you're a faggot because. And the because is the scariest part for people. I'm teaching you how to face the scary part of life so you will feel comfortable when people criticize you. Now when I hear criticism, I look at it totally differently. I no longer look at it as a dude just trying to knock me out just senselessly. I look at it as either the criticism is going to help me and improve something I'm fucking up on that I'm unaware of. That's the whole point of having scrutiny. Or I'm going to find out something about the critic that they're fucking up, that they're not accountable, and that's why they're criticizing me in the first place. So I'm going to learn either I'm not doing my job or they're not doing their job. So I'm realizing criticism is actually a good thing. It's good positively because it can fix me if I'm doing something wrong. And it's good negatively in that I will figure out if the critic is doing something wrong. You don't know how to handle that yet because you are deathly afraid of scrutiny. I know this because I was deathly afraid of scrutiny. So don't try to fucking pretend with me that you understand scrutiny or are impervious to scrutiny when you demonstrate clearly right now you're wetting your panties because of the scrutiny this class is giving you. It is to be expected. You're in stage one. It's okay to fuck up. But it's not okay to not even try to fuck up because you're worried about fucking up. The goal is for you to get your belief out you will fuck up in the process, and that is the scrutiny which you will become accustomed to and not fear anymore, and you'll be comfortable making fuck-ups. Pretender makes fuck-ups. I yelled at him last time, or I criticized him for something, but the difference is, previously when he fucked up, he's like you, he just shut down sometimes, he just leave class. Now, he may pout for a minute or two, but he can jump right back in, because criticism no longer is the same threat that it is to you currently right now. To him, it's like, just like he's starting to see it like I see it. It's either going to help you, or it's going to expose the critic. Win-win. Wouldn't you like to live in a win-win world?
So sounds like a good idea.
Sounds like a great intellectual
that's
idea.
That's the problem right there. You know exactly what you're like. Yeah, I'd love that, but you hide it. It sounds like a good idea.
It sounds like a noble pursuit, a more very moralistic course of action. Yeah. Sounds like it's academically feasible. Sounds like it would add to my vast knowledge of the world and human behavior. Are you fucking high, nigger?
Brick, I'm not expecting you to fucking come out the gate and go out on a limb and give your belief. But at least with questions, answer that clearly. Like, does
that I'm leading you. I mean, it's one thing to be on stage like me and just present your beliefs without having a roadmap from anybody else. It's another thing, and I'm holding your hand and asking you straightforward questions, and you're still refusing. If you keep refusing, I'm not gonna just spend all the time on you. I'm gonna go back to what we're talking about and ignore you. You're gonna go back to your regular life, which is being ignored. At least now I'm focusing on you. Take the opportunity. All right, I guess we're back to your regular life. Let's go.
Okay, yeah, let's go on.
Listen, we're talking about just stay in here. You'll get your feet wet. Eventually, you'll come out of your shell. We're on.
You're at Eurofag.
We're actually going to finish up answering this question. So we're in the middle of Q&A. A new guy just posted about. Why do you think it's a good idea to... Let me actually go back to the post that we're looking at. Forums. Come on, you cocksucker. Q&A. Oh, Q&A podcast. Here we go. Okay, so he's saying, how do you know that military training or law enforcement will discipline young men? Okay, we talked about the principle of discipline, and that's why I presented the idea in the first place. I was really presenting the principle behind discipline, creating self-discipline in people. But practically speaking, this guy is actually right. In actual application, the military and the police, fire department, all these places that train men to be accountable are doing exactly the opposite. They're actually alleviating accountability. They're actually teaching you how to get out of accountability. So you're right to complain about the police force and the military not producing accountable people or people who will be able to discipline others because they themselves understand the concept of self-discipline. This guy says he was a Marine, his stepdad is a Marine. And he's unwilling to spank or control his kids who are age 10, 8, 10, and 11. Why do you put the ages 11, 10, and 8? All right. Ascending to descending. Oldest to youngest. So, you're right. This is a perfect example here. This guy is a Marine. He's supposed to have discipline. He's supposed to have a drill sergeant. He's supposed to have Sergeant Gunny, who just died. Poor guy. And now, he's supposed to be the disciplined one, passing on his discipline from what he learned in the Marines to his kids. Aren't the Marines supposed to be one of the most kick-ass units in the military? They take pride and make Mother Green in their killing machine, right? They make fun of the Navy. They make fun of other, you know, the regular Army because they're super duper. And you can't even control children? It's an embarrassing statement. That's a fucking embarrassment. That really reflects on how shitty the armed services have become because of feminism, social justice warriors, etc., political correctness, this whole climate of political correctness. Not only has it produced Brick, who can't get a fucking sentence out, but it's also produced a generation of guys like Brick, like you guys right here. That's the whole reason you're here. It's produced a generation of guys who are unaccountable, and as a consequence, you can't hold other people accountable. You can't hold your own fucking children accountable!
It's so easy to fall for the trap that it will make you. That's why I wanted to join, because I thought, if I can face death, then I can face you and give you my belief. That was my thinking. And it's like, apparently even like that one Navy SEAL, who's that guy, the sniper, the guy, he speaks, he's like, oh yeah, sure. Absolutely, sir. But the guy from American Sniper, Chris Kyle or whatever his fucking name is, I hear that guy speak, I'm like, fuck, I thought SEALs were supposed to be ballsy. What? And then they hear them talk.
I love that SEALs are notorious. Like you see movies with like, what's that fucking Navy SEAL movie with like Charlie Sheen? They're all like fucking hardcore, you know.
SEALs.
Top Gun.
Just SEALs. That's what it's
SEALs,
called.
Yeah, we're tough guys. We go in missions that regular people don't want to do. And fuck, come on. You got to be kidding me. I mean, the culture of the military is just, it's a facade. when you got a Marine, a grown adult who can't take care of his children. Ah, hold on a second. All right. Okay, as I was saying, that the culture of the military, it's a sad statement when a military dad can't even control his kids. All right, go ahead, Pretender. What were you saying?
He left. Oh. Okay, well, he's gone now.
Last brick in Eurofag.
Duckface, you have opinions about the military. You may not agree with it. You may think it's silly. You may... I want to know. I just want to know your views on anything, really, because you don't speak.
I grew up, like, my grandpa was in the military, so, and I feel like, I think about that a lot, like, in my head, I will imagine that I have to be, like, some kind of harsh dude because of that, but,
You know, yeah, you're telling me all these facts
about it. Yeah, I mean, just look at me right now, you need to prompt me, like, every fucking 10 seconds, so who cares if I was raised by some fucking...
Yeah, but I want to know what you think about it. You're telling me about it, like, my dad did this, and he was in the military. I'm not asking your relation to the military, like, you had a family member. I'm asking what you think about it, your opinion. Do you think it's silly?
I don't think about it. Like, I will see it on TV, and then it's just... Bye, military.
You don't need to think about it to have a belief about it.
Yeah, that's the problem. You make it so hands off. It's just like the military is just not a part of my. It's like, okay.
Look, if I see a commercial for like pho, like Vietnamese food, I instantly know I really don't eat Vietnamese food. I don't think about Vietnamese food. I just know I don't want it. It looks gross. It looks like a lot of clear shit. I don't like vegetables that look clear. I don't like foods that look see through, transparent. So I don't like pho. I instantly have a belief about it. You are not in the military, obviously. You don't think about the military. You don't have military friends that you probably hang out with. But when people tell you, hey, we want to recruit you to the military, or here's a military thing, or here's a military issue,
yes,
instantly you have a belief about it.
I think I can weasel my way out of the military. Because I think they're stupid. So I can, that's why I think I can weasel my way out of it. Like if they, like before they had like a, like requirements that you had to like they had like a duty for everybody to go to the military when I grew up. And I was thinking about that, like, fuck, what I'm gonna do? I don't want to go to the military. I don't want to go to Afghanistan and kill people. But I know because they're stupid. I know they're stupid.
I can just lie.
I can just say, dude, I'm mentally deficient. I have this and this and this.
Yeah,
and
just do your normal routine.
All my like upbringing, I was like thinking of lies. Like, oh, I was in the mental hospital. I can name that. They don't have to take me then. And that's true, though, but I could make up, like, yeah.
Well, did you do it? My question is, did you actually outfox him? Did you get out of that?
Well, the fortunate thing was
we promoted Duckface to sergeant.
Now, listen, when I turned 18 and it was my turn to go, the Swedish government, they deleted the duty. Like, it's not a duty anymore now. So I was
Duckface,
like,
Duckface, I was like, yes. It's the same for me in my country.
Yes.
I got away as well.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah,
Duckface, you see, you do have opinions on the military. This is what I want out of you when I ask you questions like that, because when you tell me, I don't know what I think about the military. It's like, yeah, you do. You just interested me with everything you just said. You show me the way you think. You think that the military is stupid, and I'm like, I'm not used to, because I don't think about the military like this. I grew up seeing the military as like, this is where you, it's almost like a rite of passage.
2 points. What you said, most people don't trust the military because of their history. Like, especially in our country, they don't even take care of vets. You see so many homeless vets on the street.
Yep.
They don't even take care of vets. So I already know the military's corrupt from the head
also,
up, from the head
dude,
down.
I see through their lies now. Like, I see through all their bullshit because I've seen on the internet, like, live leak. I see all the beheadings and all that shit. So how can I trust, like, you know? I mean, the propaganda that the military puts out. It's
exactly.
Like, become a hero, become G.I. Joe. But
there's
known,
so much propaganda about the military. G.I. Joe movies, all these things that they're trying to sell you on the nobility of service. Well, service is noble, except when you have people abusing the service and using it for, you know, other personal reasons, or worse, they're covering up mistakes they made as leaders. I mean, the military is supposed to teach you how to be accountable. How can you trust and the military, or trust the whole concept of accountability from the military, from your superiors, if your superiors aren't even accountable, if your superiors are covering up the fucking mistakes, if the superiors are lying, then that removes all confidence. So
they don't even address, like, everything that comes out in the media, like ISIS.
Yes, there's so many.
They don't even speak about it. They don't even mention anything.
When
about
you sweep that shit under the rug, it doesn't make me go, oh, the military, I can't wait to join. It makes me go, don't fucking have anything to do with the military because they're corrupt as fuck. That's number one. Number two is, what else did you mention? You the corruption of the military, and
Live videos.
What?
The evasion.
The what? Invasion? No, no, no.
The evasion of the military, of the duty.
Evasion of duty.
Yeah.
Evasion of duty. Oh, why people try to get out of the military It's understandable why people want to get out of military. No, the other thing you mentioned was the military is stupid. I believe this wholeheartedly because there are definitely smart people in the military, but it doesn't generally attract smart people. And I think they also the culture of criticism or of a lack of criticism, lack of public scrutiny is exactly what makes people stupid. This is exactly what makes people – they're not really stupid, but this is what makes them appear stupid. Because if you remove scrutiny, if you remove criticism, then you never know if you're making a mistake. And that's how we handle the military. Their propaganda is so strong in America and other countries that they're above reproach. That's why you always hear like, how dare you criticize armed services fellows? Yeah. They're sacrificing their country. How dare you say that about the flag? How dare you say, it's always how dare you, how dare you, how dare you. But all those how dare yous, all those finger waggings are essentially saying, how dare you criticize and scrutinize what I'm doing for you? When really, how do I know you're doing anything for me if I'm not allowed to check what you're doing for me? If you're afraid of me checking, that's a huge red flag about your quote service. Nobody should be above reproach. But the fact that military has this like pseudo honorable culture, like they're really into honor. You really think it's honorable to lie to your people, your own countrymen, and then pretend like it's all based on honor and you're not allowed to criticize us because we're performing an honorable duty for you? No, that's the exact antithesis of honor. It's dishonorable to lie and sacrifice other people's lives in the process of your lies and then turn around and make it into a morality tale like, listen, we're doing everything that's moral here and noble, and that's why you're not allowed to criticize anybody in the armed services. No, that's the exact opposite of honorable. That's dishonorable to me. So I agree with you on both counts. Stupid because – But I think you didn't say why you think they're stupid. I suspect you just think they're like kids.
I saw a video today of it. There was like a military dude on the ground, and it's just the way he spoke. Like he was gonna throw one dude threw a grenade, and the sergeant filmed him. Like one dude threw a grenade, and then it didn't explode. And then he was like, nobody knew what was happening. Like, and he was like looking at the camera, and he was like, down, down, like the way he was talking, like.
Don Don, that's what he said.
He was like, Don Don. He had this weird, like, he reminded me of, like, a cartoon character from this game.
Well, Grand I Auto. Definitely...
Like, he seemed like a stupid follower. Like,
no, well, I see that same thing with Marine sergeants. Like, I heard, I'm gonna get up, and you gonna get up, and you gonna go to the left, and to the right, and if you don't, I'm gonna make you do support. And I'm just like, why do you gotta talk like that? Like, if you're really so intense, like, why would you have to put on this fake voice and put on all this...
I think they're very stupid also because I can, like... very easily slime out of their tests and shit. Like I shouldn't be able to do that with like a military, like defending your country from like an invasion or something. I shouldn't be able to be like just with a pen drop.
You could just write an excuse and they just have to lie.
I can just write an excuse. I can just check the wrong box and then I'm like, poof.
Yeah, I don't respect.
I mean, nobody's gonna come knock on my exactly, door. Like, did you talk? Was that true? Was that true? What you said?
Yeah,
nobody's gonna. I can't just.
This is exactly right. You're right. Nobody is there to hold you accountable. They're just there to take you at face value. You marked a box
face
on a
value,
form
that
could may or may not be true. But the fact that you're not willing to scrutinize it, that's why I find people the stupidest people are the people who don't scrutinize anything. They don't check anything. They don't test
I can just
anything.
Like it's all the bureaucracy. I can drown in the bureaucracy.
Exactly.
That's how I feel. I look at it like I look at myself as like an art piece. Like I'm just drowning in the bureaucracy. Like, I like my life. I even like the CVP.
It's time for you to take your Banksy spray paint can and draw like a river, and you drowning. And it's all the river's made of bureaucrats. It just suits, and you float drowning in the river.
Well, before you started calling me out for Pretender, you just like to yell in place of saying what you believe. I would look at the sergeants in the military and think, wow, those guys are tough. Look at how they yell with just reckless abandon. But now I look at them and I'm just like, phony tough guy, phony tough guy, phony tough guy, phony tough guy. The only guy that I don't think is a phony tough guy is the guy from Full Metal Jacket. Because he's technically yelling, but he's like... He's not just yelling at the top of his lungs. He's yelling for whatever is required, and sometimes he'll yell like a little bit, and then he'll yell even more. Who's the Trump Tamley's cocksucker who just made that joke? It's like the yelling fits what you do to him. Whereas with them, they're yelling at the top.
Yeah, I can understand. Like if you yell nonstop, number one, you're gonna damage your voice. I don't even know how you can yell the next day, let alone for the whole duration of basic
career.
And then if somebody's just hearing nonstop yelling. What do they think of you? Like it's just like monotone, and it's just a loud monotone at that point.
I look at it and I cringe because because they're just like, because like I'll hear a Marine sergeant that they're trying to tell them to get off the bus. Now when you get off the bus, you're gonna go liaison to the left side, jumping onto the right side. Then we're gonna go in everything. It's the same fucking tone. I'm
dude,
just like,
also,
it's gonna get boring.
Would you want to be in like a trench with that sergeant like that who isn't even in control of his emotions? Like, how is he gonna control a grenade? He would just lose his shit and be like, you just look at him and then like, good night.
Like
that split second. That split second, he should have made a decision, but instead he was like, "God, I don't." Need
that. What I'm thinking about, like, what if we lose a buddy or something, or if we lose a guy, and it's just like, and like, is he gonna be real all of a sudden, and like, let his emotions show? It's gonna be like, is he just gonna be like, "All right, we lost Johnny, and Johnny died, and now
Johnny died.
Split. You're gonna take his body, put it in the fucking machine, and then we're gonna go get out of here." I'm just like,
well, I don't want my leaders losing control of their emotions.
Yeah, I don't want it either.
This is something I've been considering for a while. Is, you know, we talk about emotions and expressing emotions here, and they're necessary to form relationships. But like, you know, I was just watching this battle rap video last time, and this nigger was criticizing this other nigger. He was saying, "Emotional, see you emotional, see you emotional." Like, it's a bad thing to show emotion, to react to things, and I can understand. Obviously, you don't want to be emotionally unhinged and let your emotions lead your decisions. But your emotions are not like
bad thing in and of themselves.
They're not bad in and of themselves. It's just they're bad if you misuse them. If you allow your emotions to determine what you do, yes, that's a bad thing. But your emotions are part of your expression arsenal. They're part of your person. They're your tool set. Like, if I am pissed off at you, then there's a certain intensity I would like to convey to you. But if I'm happy, then why would I just rely on this tone like this? Why would I be pissed off in this tone and also happy in this tone? See, when you remove the emotion, you remove your tool set. Now you have, like, one tool. You're using a screwdriver to hammer in nails. You're using a screwdriver to... you know, for every other tap for sawing wood, imagine using a screwdriver to cut wood in half. That's essentially what you're doing when you remove all your emotions. You only have one tool left, just your content of what you're saying. So I'm like, wow. I'm torn over the fact that, like, fighting, you know, when you're fighting or in war or you're battling somebody, people try to remove their emotion so they don't let people know how they're affecting them. So it seems like, that's a valid thing to do. But then on the other hand, if you don't let your emotions show, you're handicapping yourself.
But professor, that does make sense because I'm always competing with others. I want to outsmart other people. So that's why I'm hiding my emotions.
Yeah, it makes sense on the surface. But consider it this way. Let's say you're competing against somebody. Like, I compete with people playing Slither. And even if I was like, even if we're having a tournament live and I was like, and, you know, they had all the people there. They had all their laptops there. And I was one of the persons. And I lost. I'd be like, fucking motherfucker. And you'd see me lose my shit. You would see my emotions come out. Like, I'm angry at a competitor.
But, yeah, you're right.
But I don't think that would alienate you. I don't think that – I mean, the competitor might know they pissed me off. But if I do my job correctly and I beat them, so what? I mean, what have you won other than you've made me mad? You know, it's a meme saying, I got you mad. I got you mad. You mad, bro. You mad, bro. But my answer to that is yes. I'm mad because you're stupid. I have a valid reason for being mad. Not I'm just mad just because I'm unhinged or I'm unstable. So I could get
a competitive edge if I make you mad and then you lose your focus. And
yeah,
then
but
you
that's
play.
That's different. That's saying I lose my. That's essentially saying what I already said, which is you let your emotions decide what you do.
I'm not saying
let your emotions decide what you do. I'm saying you should express your emotion. Because that's how you get things done. That's how you motivate people. But I don't say you should be leading with your emotions. Meaning, you should how you feel should determine if you come to class or not. How you feel should determine if you should go to your job or not in the morning. How you feel should determine what you say to somebody. I don't think your emotions should be your guidebook for life. But I think they should be your tool set for how you get things done.
I agree with you saying you should let them, like, overpower you. Because if I was in the military, if I was in a unit and my sergeant or whoever's in charge of my unit, and somebody dies and they just pretend like nothing happened, I'd be like, what the fuck? Like, I understand, like, they don't want to look weak. They don't want to show weakness because it's in war, and they don't want to let the weakness spread. But I don't think there's anything wrong with
someone. That's the thing. Like, if I'm the enemy and I'm making you mad, I mean, you could look at that as a weakness, as, aha, we're having an effect on you. But, that, like, if you're really smart, you already know there's no such thing as a non-effect in life. For every action, there's an equal opposite reaction. So when you pretend that you're not mad or something, or you just, you know, remove emotion, it may be a psychological tactic, but if you're really smart, you know that's bullshit. So,
and the enemy would see right through that. Like, the enemy would see you being blank, but they would know, like, I just shot your friend, so
yeah.
you are mad inside, and you're not showing it.
Right, so the facade of, like, we're both pretending, like, I'm showing emotionless and I'm stoic, and you're emotionless and stoic, so we're supposed to believe that you're really emotionless and stoic in real life? I mean, it's either you believe it and you're affected by it, because the whole goal is, I'm not affected by you, so psychologically, I'm winning. But the win to me is whether you accomplish your goal, not whether your opponent is showing some emotion or not.
For me, what would be really disheartening would be like, yeah, you got me emotional, but like, guess what? I'm emotional, but I'm still going to kick your ass at whatever it is we're doing.
Yeah.
Like, hey, great. I cried because you killed my friend, but guess what? I'm going to organize my unit now, and now we're coming after you. To me, that's more scary when a guy overshows his emotion, he overcomes it, than a guy who just, okay, pretends like it doesn't affect him and just gets on. I'm just like, okay, great. This guy's, when I see a guy that, when I'm playing a game and I'm on voice chat and a guy is forcing to pretend like what I've done hasn't affected him, I know that I'm going to win. Because that guy, he not only does he have to do all the mental calculation to beat me, now he has to do all the mental energy it takes to suppress what the fuck he's feeling. So you're adding extra work for no reason. And I'm like, he's more concerned with looking tough to me than winning. Because if you're really focused on achieving your goal, you're not going to give a fuck what the opponent thinks about you showing emotion. You're going to be so focused on winning that it's just like, I'm focused on my goal. So
that's a great point. Yeah, that's a great point. Okay, did we finish all this? My other concern. Oh, okay. So the second part of this question, I think we answered the first part of the question about the military. So, yeah, I do agree with this guy that the military is not trustworthy at this point because of the leadership. It's always the leadership's fault, by the way, for any problem. It's always the leaders. You work with the leaders. Yes, that is a problem. Would you think that guys in the military like this could be relied on to be mature men? Obviously, we answered that question. So I like the concept, but if I was going to implement the concept of like compulsory service in military or police force, fire department, etc., I would have to design it. I would have to redesign it, what is currently there, which means I would have to allow for scrutiny of what's going on. Right now, you're not allowed to scrutinize the military, and that's why it's so shitty in the first place. So I would immediately, if I'm implementing a new system where everybody has to be accountable, so like when you hit 18, everybody has to serve, I would say, yes, that's the new policy, but also the new policy is we now open up the leadership to scrutiny. So whatever we're doing, our methods for training people, our results, our, you know, basic training, all the things that people are doing, those are now open to scrutiny, and no longer are you not allowed to criticize them because it's dishonor, or it's seen as a besmirch of their honor or some bullshit excuse like that. My other concern is with women in the military and law enforcement. Okay, when I say compulsory military service or domestic service, I mean males, not females. Because men only, because women will have also compulsory duty. I actually think that women should also have compulsory duties, like
cooking.
Domestic duties, cooking, childbearing, all those things that you have the capacity to do because you have the womb for it, you have the function for it.
I was thinking my mom is a great cook and she helped me so much during the college years since she prepared great food. She kept the house clean, she kept the clothes clean, and I didn't have to think about it at all.
That's
all
great that your mom can do that.
But yeah, my mom does the same shit.
Women of this generation, I've been on dates where women, like, they brag about not being able to cook. Like, I don't know how to cook a shit. I don't know how to cook anything. I'm not thinking, oh, that's funny. I'm thinking, you useless cunt. What are you good for? That's one of the major duties of women, and you can't perform it. What are you good for? That's like bragging, hey, I don't get blowjobs. I don't have sex. Okay, then why am I even dating you? Okay. So yes, I compulsory for men, not for women. Women should have other compulsory. What should be a compulsory duty for women? If men have to sign up for military service or domestic service,
I know
what.
they shouldn't be in the society at all. They should always listen to
be in the
to the guys.
So you're gonna remove them from society?
No,
yeah.
Come on.
I want
why
them.
Not? You're
fact,
I don't want them.
You're all fact. Fucking state this clearly, because I know what you're trying to say, but you say it so retardedly when you say they should.
If
be
you say if you remove women from society,
yeah,
like how will you even exist? You'll become extinct.
You're
or I guess
no,
you don't mean not fuck
I'm not
them,
saying like
you
remove them,
not
like exterminate them. I'm saying like remove them like from jobs altogether, all kind of jobs. They should only do. Like house cleaning and
that
like
is a job.
Kids.
House cleaning is a job.
So okay, here I'll say it since you're not gonna say it. I want women to be under the care of their fathers, and they should stay under the care of their fathers and live with their fathers, and their fathers provide for them until they find a husband or their father finds them a husband, and then it's transferred from one man to another man. That is a good system.
That makes great sense, because if men are compelled to sacrifice their lives to serve women, then women should also be compelled to sacrifice their lives to serve men. So if men have to serve in the military, then women should have to serve under the authority of men. That makes perfect sense, and that sounds like a perfectly perfectly
win-win.
Balanced trade-off. Because if I'm compelled to sacrifice my life...
Then men have to be trained to be accountable. Because
yes,
I know
right.
So many girls which have fathers that are fucking...
Well, you're right. That's part of the problem. Fathers are irresponsible.
Yes.
You know... You're right. So there has to be accountability on both sides. That's why men have to learn how to be accountable in order to be in charge. And then women have to learn how to be under male authority, which means they have to have accountable men taking care of them. So you're right.
Speaking of holding men accountable, Eurofag, you need to say what I said. You need to stop just hiding your view behind this like thing like we should remove women from society. I feel like you just say things like that because you want to be edgy. And you think that that's going to get my attention.
He sounds
just
like a MGTOW who's like his goal is a MGTOW is to like abandon society altogether. Like I'm going to run away from American women and go to the Philippines and fuck
okay, so you're a hooker. Try again. Give your view again. How do you think? What do you think of some of the duties of women? And don't say some dumb shit like they shouldn't be part of society because that's not what you think.
No, that's exactly what I think. They should not.
No, listen.
It's a long fucking convoluted. It's a long convoluted point. But
how will you make it practical? How are you practically going to remove women from society? How are you going to do that?
He doesn't mean.
He's exactly like Pretender said. Like
that's
under the care of the.
Removing them from society. They're a part of society. Their role is just different. When you say that you're removing them from society, it's like you're taking them out of the country or taking them out or something.
Yeah, because children should be under the authority of their parents. But you're not removing them from society. I will still see them walking on the streets. I'll still see them in shops. I'll still see them at, public places. So when you're talking about removing them from society, I'm like, what are you, a Muslim? I mean, what the fuck are you talking about?
Yeah, I imagined that you were going to take all males and put them on one island and then all the females
No.
Put them like in a cage somewhere. Like, we need a female to fuck. Let's go to the island, fly to the island where we removed all the females. And then let's get a female and bring them in to fuck them. And then we'll put them back on their island, in their cage.
No. When I speak society, I speak like jobs that like are bone breaking jobs.
Why don't you say remove them from this type of job or from jobs altogether?
You mean remove
them
from the workforce?
From the workforce.
Yeah, but society is different from the workforce. Why would you say society and not the workforce?
Yeah, when I think about society, I think about like the things that needs to be built and the things that like keeps.
Do you realize buildings
moving.
Are in society? Do you realize public
what?
Places? Do you realize malls are in society? Do you realize? Concerts, music concerts are in society. You realize society comprises a lot of human institutions and activities
and
events.
I
right?
I see society. Like I maybe my definition about society is fucked, but
you're not accountable to your definition, and maybe that's the problem. We're teaching you how to be accountable. Essentially, Pretender is saying be specific, which means don't be a woman who is not accountable to her words and actions. Be a man who is accountable to his words and actions.
Yeah. So basically removing them out of the workforce, and then I would think
again. Women need to do work. I don't want lazy women. And
work is
good for everybody. So why wouldn't they do work? Like cleaning the house is work. Taking care of a child is work.
Is work.
Cooking food is work. So when you say remove all jobs, I'm thinking so that means remove cooking jobs too. Remove house cleaning jobs too. Remove domestic child care duties too.
No.
What should they do?
They should be under the father's authority, and they should like listen. They should listen to them, and they should like learn from the mother.
Yeah, but if I was a woman, I wouldn't want to listen to you. I would be justified. I'd be like, you're retarded. You're dangerous. You would get me killed, or you would give me a miserable life. There's no way I would want to be under your authority as a woman.
Why?
Well,
because
you're not even accountable to your words. You just said remove me from society and give me zero labor.
Dude, but I didn't finish my fucking points. That's the point.
You haven't even started your fucking point.
It's not about finishing your point. It's about how your accountability to all your points in general. You're not an accountable guy. You know, you're not trained to be accountable. I wouldn't want to submit to you. I don't even want to be your friend. So if I can't even trust you with friendship, why would a woman want to entrust you with her life?
Good point.
Well, because the way things are going right now.
Listen, you're a fact. That's why I don't like websites like Return of Kings. Because they say how women are bitches, women are this, yada, yada, yada. And I'm like, women are justified to be bitches, though. Because there's guys like you. So it's like,
real point.
Like, listen.
Bitch isn't like something you choose. I realize. I used to think it was. Like, you just become a bitch. No, bitch is really saying, I'm fulfilling a void, a vacuum. Like, if a man is not in charge. Really, that's what a bitch is. It's a woman trying to assume male authority, which means there's an authority vacuum. It means there's no authority. There's no governance. There's nobody leading. There's nobody in charge. So that's why women are bitches, because men don't put their foot down. Men don't draw a line in the sand. Men don't say no. Men don't say this has to be done to this standard. If you don't have somebody in charge, there's a vacuum.
That's why it's like, look, I don't like bitch. Like, don't get this twisted. Bitch behavior is still repulsive. I still don't like seeing a bitch. But ultimately, the people I really get mad at are the dudes. Like, one time I was listening to this radio show, and this guy was talking about, I don't tolerate this from a girl, I don't tolerate that from a girl, and he was a black guy. And one of the black callers calls in and he says, look, man, that may work with them white girls, but listen to me, man. If you say that to a black girl, they gonna whoop your ass. And I'm just like, that is exactly why black chicks are the worst. Because of that, it's like, you gotta get one of them goo goo ga bitches from Africa. Those are the only girls. No, you're a goo goo ga bitch. That's why black girls are bitches. That's why they are, because of the guys, not because of the girls. They're not inherently bitches. You're a bitch.
Yeah.
And it's like nobody wants to say that. And because here's the thing. If I say that, right, if I speak up and tell guys, you're a bitch, then you know what I'm afraid of them saying to me?
They're going to thank you.
Yeah. Well, not just that. They're going to say, where's your, okay, so you're a tough guy, right? Where's your girl? Where's your wife? Where's your woman that you're keeping in check? And I'm like, I don't feel confident enough to answer that because I don't have it. I haven't demonstrated the ability to keep woman in check. But even then, I still think like, you know what, man, fuck that. I could do better with your girlfriend. Like,
yeah, but then you could also make the argument that, okay, I don't have a woman, but you have a woman. So you're basically saying live like me. Okay, what is your life like now that you have a woman? Well, now we know it, just as you mentioned, I can't say anything to a black woman because she'll beat me to death. So he's trying to say, listen, it's bad that you don't have a woman, but I got a situation where the woman's in charge and I have to worry about what I say and I have to behave like a spineless little bitch because I can't speak up for fear of offending my woman. I can't direct my life because she might disapprove of one of my decisions and I might get beat for it, which is better. He's essentially saying, you're worse off because you have no woman controlling your life. I'm better off because I have a bitch controlling me. That's essentially what he's saying.
Yeah, no. I would say,
yeah, I never thought of it like that. I always assume it's a fail if I don't have a girlfriend.
Yeah, that's what I thought too. I'm like, oh, I don't have a girl. That's the ultimate trump card. But then I realized, no, it's not just having a woman. It's what is your life like now that you have a woman? Because
yeah,
there's dudes
right.
who can't even fucking hang out because they're like, oh, I check with my girlfriend. I got to check with her. And it might not work out, guys. I might not be able to hang out with you. What? Then what is it? So you're essentially saying, guys, I volunteered for a prison with pussy in it, but I'm stuck in it. I can't do anything. I can't leave it. I'm stuck. I have no more autonomy to make decisions. I can't hang out with friends anymore. I can't do anything I want to do because this woman is now in charge. I've entered into a slavery contract with a plantation owner.
That's exactly why I used to support MGTOW when I was younger, when I was like 13, 15. I used to watch Everybody Loves Raymond, and it's always Ray is getting like just bitched at by his wife every day, and he has to go.
I've seen that guy cower in one of those fucking shows where he got his wife mad, and he was discussing with this other tall faggot. They're like two huge dudes, like over six feet, and they're we might get the woman mad, and the woman comes in, and then like you could see Raymond, his body like curls up, and he's hiding, he's trying to hide behind the couch. I mean, this grown man acting like a complete fucking faggot, like it's a normal thing for guys to do. It's a disgusting statement about the state of society today, about guys today, and what they think of their role in relationship to women, that women are in charge of them. Oh, I got a cower.
So demotivating. It's so demotivating, especially as a boy. When I was 13, I was just like, I would look at that and I'm like, I am never getting married. Like, I made that decision when I was 13. I'm like, I'm never getting it for this? Are you fucking kidding me? And it's like, the woman's always bitching at him. And I never saw anything else. I never saw any good marriages that showed me that there was another way to do it. So as far as I'm concerned, that's just the way it is. All the women that I saw in my life, they were all the people that were involved in schooling and being involved in like trying to direct me were all chicks. very few dudes, and the dudes that were involved, they were either in the process of divorcing their women because they were bitches. And I even told one guy, I said, I was talking shit about this guy's ex-wife to him when I was like 13. I was like, dude, that chick, she dropped us off, but the whole time she was like, she was constantly busting my balls and blah 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 blah. And it's like, and then he whispers to me, this is what he says. He says, yeah, that's why I divorced her. And I'm like, this guy's actively embracing this. Like, they just admit it. They're just like, yep, this is just the way it is. Like, there's no incentive to get married because no one will tell me, hey, you do this, you can get this, you can get pussy. I want to see a show where it's like, hey, you're going to get pussy. Hey.
Yeah. Imagine a sitcom. Hey, guys, you're going to get pussy. That's exactly why I stopped watching sitcoms and stopped watching TV, because you see just the, you see, like, everybody's just like Raymond. They're all cowering faggots. Like, why would I be inspired to watch a guy cower like a fucking faggot? That's not something I want to watch. I want to see a show where, yo, dude, you're going to get some pussy.
The thing is, even when they do get pussy on those shows, it's after they like clap their fucking hands like a seal and bounce a ball in their nose.
Yeah, so I've done dishes today, honey. Can I get a blowjob?
Oh, dude, no.
I was looking for some pictures for something, and I saw this dude with like this guy washing dishes, and the chick's like underneath, like right kneeling down the counter, like she's about to give him a blowjob. So it's implying like, honey, look at me being so good and domestic. I'm doing all the chores. Oh, you're being such a good boy. Fine. Okay, here's your blowjob.
I was like, fuck. Dude, I used to think that I was a pussy who couldn't talk, who would like, because like, after I train here, a lot of the training here.
You still
like,
are
says,
a pussy though.
Huh?
You still are a pussy though.
I agree. But here's
no,
the
you
thing.
Don't. You just said in past tense, like it's your past life, like you've sailed on, you've graduated.
Then I need to be clear. I'm less of a pussy than
I don't think you need to be clear. I think you need to stop lying to yourself.
Okay,
stop,
then, I'm a
number
pussy.
Number one, stop lying to me, because that's who I care about. And number one for you, there's actually not a number two. It's really number one for you, because it's your perspective. You need to stop lying to yourself, and then stop lying to me second. On my side, it's stop lying to me first, stop lying to you second. But on your side, it's stop lying to you first, and stop lying to us second.
Okay.
Look,
well,
we're having a discussion, and you're on board, and you learn new things to change your life. That's good. But denying and rewriting the past just makes you a liberal.
No, I'm still a pussy.
I don't think you believe it. Now it's academy training time. Now it's stop fucking moralizing to me and give me your actual belief. Because I don't think you think you're not a pussy.
I think I have more boundaries. I think I have more balls than most guys. I think I have more balls than most. Like,
okay,
I
want to hear your beliefs, though. I don't want to hear me scolding you and saying, yes, I need to adopt your belief. You're right.
No, I think I have more balls than most guys. I don't meet your standard, obviously.
No, I agree with you, though. When you say you have more balls than most guys, I agree with that statement. I agree you do.
Yeah, I agree with it, too. Because, like, lately, I've been – the last few times I've had sex with girls, I haven't been able to keep a hard on. And it's always been because it's like the girl does something where it's like there's some implication where it's, hey, if you do this my way, I'll do this for you. I'll give you a blowjob. And every time there's that there, I just don't want to fuck her anymore. I'm just not interested anymore. And I used to think that, like, you know, pretender, you think you're a tough guy because you're at the academy and the academy teaches you about being in charge of a woman. But when push comes to shove, you're just going to take a woman being in charge of you. But at the very least, I have enough boundaries, enough balls to say I at least – now, listen, I don't have the balls to take charge of a woman and be accountable for a woman. But at the very least, I have the balls to say, like, no, I'm not going to let you control me. I'm not going to just let you tell me what to do and be like – and be okay with it, because literally it just turns me off. It fucking turns me off. I don't like it when women like say things like even when women try to like direct what I do in the bedroom. Like this one girl, I was enjoying grabbing her hips, and she kept trying to fucking grab my wrist and put my hands in her ass. And I was like, and I didn't have the balls to call her out, but I just kept moving my hands back up to her hips, and she kept trying to push it down. I'm stronger than you, bitch. You're not gonna push my hands down. She kept going, and I just eventually couldn't even keep a boner. Like I was fucking kissing her, but it's like. There was, like, passion the kiss before, but now it's just, like, lips mucking about with each other. It's just, like, I'm not into this at all anymore.
That reminds me, like, we play this bad girl, good girl thing sometimes in bed, and I'm like, you're naughty girl. And then when she feels like she's done everything I'm saying, she's just like, I'm your good girl, right? I'm your good girl, right? And that annoys me so much because, like, I'm the one who will let you know if you're doing what I like or not. And at one point, I was so turned off. And then I remember, like... three times or four times later, however many times later, I finally, she asked me that question, and then, this was later, like, fucking, like, again and again and again, and then, like, probably the fourth time, she's like, I'm your good girl, right? And I'm like, shut the fuck up. Jesus, I'm naughty. And I realized instantly that was what was wrong. It was really not her telling me that. It was annoying that she was telling me that, But what was more annoying was that I just let it slide and I didn't say anything. And as soon as I said, shut the fuck up, she was like, she nodded. And then it was like, oh, see? I can control the environment and I should be controlling the environment. I should be the one that doling out whether I think it's good or not. Not she's like, you know, trying to say, is this, you know, I will lead this now passively, but I will be leading it. So I realized, oh, shit. See, even I still have that, like, kind of conditioned response that I've been had from the past is just like, you know, always defer to women. So it was kind of a
Why did it bother you that she says I'm a good girl? Like,
am I a good girl?
Because I knew that she was like she was getting me to try to say it, like, to validate that she's a good girl, she's doing this thing, when it's my job to give the validation, not her job to, like, it's like somebody telling you a joke and saying, that's funny, right? That's funny, right? It's funny, right?
Oh, got it.
I mean, I will laugh if it's funny. I don't need you to tell me to laugh at it. So that when she's like, I'm a good girl, right? I'm a good girl. Oh, so I realized
that makes sense.
Telling her to shut the fuck up was the correct thing. And it felt good in the moment because now I was, like, back in there and it was like, anyway, it's a sexual side story, but it tied into that.
you just, I think this conversation.
Oh. Looks like part three is coming up. Hold on, we're starting. Okay, we're back. Go ahead.
Okay, so this reminds me, because I've been looking up lately, I've been doing so much Google searching about erectile dysfunction, how to solve it and all that. And I think your story in combination with mine has kind of, like, shown me, like, I'm not this guy with low testosterone. I don't have, like, something physically wrong with me. That's why I have a deficiency in that. The problem is something turns me off and I don't fucking call it out. I tolerate it. That's the fucking problem. That's it. Because even when I'm thinking...
It's funny that you mentioned it, because that's exactly what I've been experiencing lately is my dick goes soft, and I'm like, I know exactly why, but I know also that I'm not willing to do something about it. And it's not necessarily because I don't want to do, or I can't do something about it. It's just that this is not the girl that I would do something about it with. Like, other girls, I would, but this girl, I just don't care. So it's unfortunate because I'm like, I realize sometimes I just, like, I go soft, and I'm like, I know why.
I do the same thing. Like, this girl, when she keeps grabbing my wrist, I'm like, Jesus, am I fucking a woman or a man? Like, shut your stupid ass up and just ride me and shut up. And she keeps trying to take control and she... Dude, the worst part. Oh my God, the worst part. I let her fucking, like, because I was so turned off, I just checked out. Huh?
I thought you were going to say she pegged you.
No. No. It was almost that bad, though. I just started, like, playing with her pussy, and I wasn't into it at all. And so I was terrible. I didn't even want to become good. And so she started, like, this is how I knew I was terrible, too. She started giving me advice on how to do it, and I'm like, oh, my God.
Oh.
This is the worst. This is the worst, because, like...
Draw the alphabet with your tongue.
Dude, I wasn't going to eat her out. Fuck that. But, like, I was playing with her, and my forearm was getting sore, and I'm like, Jesus, when is this going to be over? Oh my God, please just let this be over. See, when I'm, because I don't, what I should say is just like, yeah, we're done. That's what I should say. I'm just like, I'm turned off, not into this, but I don't want to do that because I don't want to offend the woman. I don't want to offend the girl because pleasing her is more important than pleasing myself. Well, my attitude should be, listen, bitch, if I'm pleased, you'll be pleased. Because if when I'm pleased, your sexuality reacts to mine. If I'm having a good time, you're going to have a good time. That's the way it should be. Because all the best sex I've had
is happiness is mutual. There's no such thing as single person happiness, because if you're happy if you're happy and the other person's happy, it's really like time-based happiness. It's very temporal, which means it's not in homeostasis. It's not in equilibrium. There's some like you've thrown a ball up, but you forgot to calculate that it's coming back down. It hasn't reached equilibrium yet. So if you're happy and the other person's unhappy, you're not really happy. You're pleased with something, but ultimately in the long run, it's going to cause you a problem. Real, real genuine happiness is a mutual condition. It's a mutual result of you playing your role and her playing her role and you getting her to play her role. When those two things are in harmony, then everybody has a reason to be happy. When one or the other person is happy at the expense of the other person and the other person's not, that means there's something wrong. There's some wrong thing going on. All right, let's finish up this question here. My other concern is with women in military, blah, blah, blah. Are those really the best places? No. Shouldn't women be learning skills more typical to what they need to be doing, like homemaking? Yes.
Yes.
I've come up with a proposal of my own. Tell me if it sounds stupid or not. Let's see. Why don't we send women to take care of orphans for a couple years? Sure, why not? I don't know.
That actually seems like a good idea.
The government could give them some kids and some cash. Whoa, I'm already on off here. I don't want to give women kids and cash. I will give women kids, but under obviously male direction, and cash to guys to spend it so that they can... It would operate just like a regular family would. The guy would be spending, in charge of spending, and the woman just takes care of whatever the guy bought and handles it accordingly. She's basically the delegate, delegate authority. And some cash and send it to food, blah, blah, clothes, company, and cleaning of the orphanage. Then a government official, an equivalent of a for the drill instructor, could daily or semi-daily or whatever check that she is doing everything right. I guess that's, yeah, that's pretty much like, you're basically you're creating an artificial family in this kind of dysfunctional situation where, you know, there's orphans around. This way women could learn the best skills that suit them and orphan children could get more care than like they need. Okay. If we do this along with sending men into the military and each social, and then each societal group, men and women and children would get the help or skills they need. I'd love to hear what you guys say. All right. We answered it. All right. Is there anything else we need to cover?
I don't know. You tell me.
I don't know. It's your class.
Oh,
I'm just, I'm just here to react to your problems.
I thought you meant like are there more questions that they asked.
I don't know. What's going
not
on?
Not really. I'm satisfied.
We can go over your songs. We can go over your songs if you want.
Yeah, I want to go over my songs.
All right, let's do it. Where's your
okay.
song?
Okay.
Let's see here.
The music before was very important to me. Now it's not anymore. Like you said, Professor, now it's more of a...
Music is before, what? I didn't hear what you mumbled to yourself or muttered to yourself.
Bunny boy, I don't want to go over your music when you're committed to my belief. I really don't, dude. Like, I was interested in class, and now I'm not, now that we're going over music. Not because we're going over the music, but because when you talk about it, I know you're going to bore me. Don't commit to my belief. Tell me your belief about the music and interest me.
Well, I don't trust myself.
Duckface, are you there?
Duckface,
are you there?
Yeah.
What's up, bro?
What are your opinions on everything that's been happening, especially the sex talk? I'm curious about that, because I know I said exactly what I thought about that. I want to know you, and I saw you smirking in the background, so I'm curious your opinion.
Well, I had similar experience that you had, like, with Flugengirl, actually, that was here before in Discord. Like, she would also do things like we would be in bed, and I would be like, I feel like I would try to spank her, and she would be like, don't do it like that. She would try to steer me some way, and I would get the same response. Like, I smiled because I feel like I've been through everything that you just explained. Like, I even like started thinking, like, is there like an erectile dysfunction thing here? Because I experienced the same thing. Like, instant boner instant boner. Like,
and I'm so glad it's not just me. Because sometimes I think, because I always think, like, because especially when I see, like, porn stars, and the porn star girls, they're always bitches, and the guys manage to stay
well,
hard.
Well, they need the Viagra, though.
Even amateur, not even just, like, super professional, just, like, amateur guys, they can, like, stay really hard, and I'm like, how do they do that? Like,
well, number one, you're assuming that amateur is amateur. I mean, there's professional amateur. Do you realize that?
Yes, I do.
No, you don't.
Yes, I know that. I've seen
it. There's also pretend like you could be like half boner too. I've been like disturbed by that too. I could get like I would be like semi hard.
You could also
I think that's I've seen a lot of that in porn. Like
you could also be desperate though. Like if you're super desperate for sex, like you are hard like at a you know the wind blows in your heart. So it's not just I mean there's any number of reasons. Not necessarily that they're just like super super hard just because they're you know they're pros. A lot of it is like mental problems. Like if you're addicted to sex, addicted to porn, whatever. A lot of times you can be hard and be thinking about sex like abnormally long because of you are so worried about not finding a girl, not getting a relationship, etc. That now it becomes an obsession for you. So you have like also abnormal habits as a result of that.
I think I know what it is. So I don't think that's it. I think because amateur clips, they're always like 5 minutes long. So you don't if I made a sex tape that was like 16 minutes long, you would see like a,
5 minutes. I think you could stay high.
One of these. What's it in English? You would see a semi boner or like
floppy dick.
I would go limp. Yeah, exactly. At some point. At some point.
In Bunny Boy's country, they call it floppy dick.
Floppy dick, yeah.
Flappy
bird. You will see a flappy bird at some
flappy
point.
Flappy bird.
I think they must be like covering it up, like because amateur clips are always like 5 minutes, three
the
minutes.
Is for, this is.
They pick the best part, dude. They pick the part.
You sure they don't pick the part where they take it off her blouse? Lifting
you think
up
the part? You think they picked the part where the dude gets humiliated?
No.
They don't want to show that.
But this is the problem, dude. Like, this is why I don't like life. Because it's like, I'm realizing how vulnerable I am to other people and society. Because it's like, for every conversation like this, where it's like, you guys will tell me things and I can have a conversation that makes me say, oh, it's not because of something wrong with me, it's because of the way I'm handling it. There's all these forms and all these things that tell me, you should try, when you jerk off, every time you're about to come, stand up. And when you stand up, you'll accustom your body to...
Well, that's because, like, just like with dentistry now and medicine now, it's profitable to create problems and then solve them. Like, it's profitable for fast food industries to exist and to make people into human whales so that the medical industry can now solve all those problems. Because the whole medical industry, or half of it, goes away if you just give people better nutrition.
So yeah, I'm thinking about the same way about the low-fat milk. For example, they will tell you that low-fat milk is good and sell you a low-fat milk, and then all the fat that they got out of the milk will sell you separately as a butter. So they sell you the same milk twice.
Cool.
I don't know.
Bonnie Boy, what are you trying to tell me? Because, like, I didn't, if you commit to your belief, this will be easy. You won't just tell me facts. Okay, fine.
Yeah, I'm telling...
Go ahead. Just say you want to fit in. Just say you want to fit in.
Yeah, you're right. I want to fit in. I want to talk to you. I want to participate in the conversation.
I don't like you, though. You know why I don't like you?
You don't.
Because I'm not committed to my own opinion. But that the thing that you don't like me, actually, because I believe so much that if I'm committed to your opinion and if I give you a correct answer, that I will like you. That the more I know that you don't like me, the more I commit to your opinion. Because I feel, okay, if I commit so more to your opinion, then you will like me. Like, I'm not committing enough.
You're not committing enough. You need to overcommit.
Yeah.
That's actually pretty honest. Because that's exactly how I think about it.
I was thinking, Bonbo, like, yeah, you should talk English. Like, what are you saying when you're saying committed? Like, trying to commit. I think, like, you were saying before, you're trying to talk about the same topic. That's what you were doing. Like now, like you're trying to talk about the same. You were trying to talk about the same topic. Like you're trying to.
You're like, we have a commonality. You have this problem. You are seeing this problem in society. I also see it. We're on the same page. We're bros.
Yeah. Like they said that with the milk thing. Like butter. They remove the milk out of the butter. So.
Yeah, because the thing with the milk.
What do you really think?
Go ahead, Darkface. Fuck it, Darkface.
What do you really think? You should say what do you really think about the butter thing. Like, what do you really think about the milk? Like, you're probably thinking about that anyway.
Darkface, or not Darkface. But anyway, what I'm thinking when you said the milk thing, I'm like, that's smart. Why would you waste fat? You got fat from the cow. Get some for milk.
I don't even understand his point because I think it's stupid. Yeah. I thought they just took the milk and churned it and it became butter. So it doesn't make sense to me that to remove the fat, that doesn't even sound feasible. I don't even trust what he's saying.
Low fat milk or something. I don't know.
The butter process. I always thought like they just had milk from a cow. They churned it and then you got butter from that. So I don't even understand what he's saying. Like you take the fat out and now you have butter. Like that doesn't make any sense to me.
Well, I'm not a pseudo farmer, so I didn't think.
I'm not a farmer either, but that's just what I think.
Well, I'm not a farmer either, but listen, if you wanna.
Yeah, but okay, so then your claim sounds like bullshit, because it just sounds like you're making a claim that may or may
not
be
really
true.
You know, I don't know how do you call it in English. When you have a cream from the milk, you do it if you heat the milk and then let it cold. On the surface of the milk, you will get the fat collected, and then you can collect that fat and eat it, and you will be left with a low fat milk.
So you take the excess fat.
Fat will form on the top of the milk. You never done that? I mean, that means you've never had access to a full fat milk. That's what I'm talking about. If I go to a countryside and I get a milk or I buy a milk on the market that's full fat, and if you just put it on the stove and heat it and then let it cold.
So are you saying low fat milk is essentially the milk we get in like the cartons, just standard milk we're used to drinking? Okay,
yes.
So it's not the real thing. It's not real genuine milk with the fat and everything.
Well, I thought they had whole milk.
What?
I thought they had whole milk. They have all versions of milk. Like, you could go to McDonald's.
But it's not real whole milk. It's not real whole milk. It's not... They brand it as whole milk, but it's not really...
I don't know that, though.
I think, according to what he just said,
well,
I trust
according
him.
To him, but again, I don't trust him, and you are somehow able to trust him. I don't know if he's a milk...
I trust him because I've seen real milk in, like, YouTube videos and, like, documentaries, like, where it's, like, they pull out the milk, and there's the white milk that you see, and then there's, like, this excess goopy shit that's the fat. So it's plausible what he's saying based on what I've seen.
Yeah, my grandma used to make the cream.
I don't know if I even care.
Okay, well.
Yeah, that's the main issue.
Come in.
All right.
I'm failing so hard in this class. Like any other.
All right. Shit. I guess we're gonna pull your high school girl routine. You're gonna let your song speak for you. Go ahead.
My slogan?
Your song speak for you.
Oh, okay. The first song is Beatles Yesterday. That's when I was in elementary school before the sex came in. So that's before puberty. Like,
all my troubles seem so far away.
This is the exact opposite of you.
What do you mean?
Like this is a depressing song, and it's kind of like melancholy while being sweet. It's like a bittersweet song. And you're like a skim milk off the top that I just throw away. You're the fat on the top of the skim milk that I just throw away.
Yeah, but the fat on the milk is the most nutritious part of the milk. You don't throw that away.
Well, but I would throw you away. I mean, you're probably a nutritious human being full of vitamin-enriched thoughts and feelings about the world, but I don't see it, so I just throw you away. This song, I can see it. I can hear it. So I keep it. You, I throw away.
That sucks.
Yeah, what sucks worse is that you are in charge of whether I throw it away or not. It's really you who decide whether I throw you away or not, not me. I am acting just in a justified according way, according to how you make me decide. Like, you are in charge of whether I throw you away or not. So you are essentially saying, it's okay to throw you away. The Beatles song is saying, you can try to throw me away, but other people will prevent you. If I try to throw away the Beatles song, people will be like, are you out of your fucking mind? The Beatles are iconic. This song is amazing. It changed my life because of da-da-da-da. If I say, hey, throw Bunny Boy away, they'll go, yeah, he's probably got Down syndrome. He sounds like a retard anyway. Go ahead. We might be throwing away Einstein.
So weird hearing the song so full of life and then hearing you just sit there. There's nothing going on. What do you think of the song? Because here, I'll tell you what I think of the song. I think of, like, my life is sad enough. Why the fuck do I need to listen to more sad songs? Like, I want to listen to... That's why I like
to commiserate. If I have a sad life, sad
songs
make me commiserate.
I don't
want to
commiserate. It makes me more sad. Because you know why?
It soothes me to know that there's other people that are in pain and suffering.
It doesn't soothe me. It makes me more sad. It makes me... It makes it worse for me. Because when I commiserate, it makes me feel hopeless. That's why I like to listen to happy music. Like music like,
if I'm sad and I'm listening to happy music, I feel like I'm pretending, like I'm forcing myself to be happy.
Why?
With that.
Why
because
don't you
I'm not really happy. I want to cry, and then you put a happy song and
yeah. If your mom just died and you actually like your mom, and then they put on like a happy song, it's like how you're trying to uplift me and cheer me up, but I don't know how you're removing the pain by giving some uplifting song when you're not really, it's not really acknowledging like my suffering as a result of that.
I want to escape my suffering. Like,
but I don't think just saying putting on a happy song makes me escape from that. I guess maybe a distraction. Like if I you know take a drug or take heroin and then I numb the pain, I've escaped. I understand why people drink alcohol, but the music, a happy song isn't alcohol. It's not even close to me to being alcohol. I would rather have the alcohol than the happy song.
The thing is, with music, I don't listen. I'm trying to figure out why I don't listen to sad songs. Because I just don't do it. I don't do it because it's like, I think it's boring. And it doesn't move me in a way that even when it does move me, it doesn't move me in a way I want to go.
All right, listen, I don't necessarily even like that sad song. That is not one of my favorite songs. I've actually heard this song so much that Yesterday is really annoying. I actually turn it off whenever I hear it. Here's one of my sad songs. Let's see if you what you think about this sad song. Let me see. Cut your wrist.
Dude, Professor, I was thinking in the beginning of class, like you said, like that a dude like me, I should listen to like Megadeth or something, right?
No, not I mean, should that you that
do
you
that I do that you think that I do?
Yeah,
listen to things like that.
Like
I don't do
not,
that.
Not necessarily you, but like a Bunny Boy, like a more quiet version. You're quiet, but you're not that quiet. Bunny Boy is more quiet.
But I don't listen to that anymore. I used to listen to that.
Listen, I don't like you. So you trying to justify it through information does not help me like you more, Bunny Boy. And plus, I already think you're lying. I used to be a bad guy, but now I'm a good guy. I'm a moral guy. Your double, your morality speech on top of your dick sucking is just as repulsive. It's double repulsive. Congratulations. Duckface. By the way.
Yeah. I don't listen to Megadeth and stuff like that. But I was thinking, I listen to Gun Sounds and stuff like that, though.
Gun Sounds? What do you mean, Gun Sounds?
Like Guns N' Roses?
No, gun sounds. Like, I like this sound.
Oh, gun sounds. Like, I actually do that too.
But that's the music, though. That's the music, though.
What do you mean, gun sounds? I don't understand what you're talking about.
I this is a YouTube video of this game I play, and one of the vehicles you can use is a tank that has a very powerful cannon. And there's a video where it just shoots over and over and over again, and it sounds so
booming
and powerful.
Is it like like creating a beat, or is it just the sound of the boom? Because I don't understand. I saw
from Syria, like clips from Syria. I saw.
Well, it's the sound of the boom, and I think like
there's a sound when the bullet travels so fast.
Are you talking about the rhythm? Like you're creating songs with your death, or just the sound itself?
The sound itself. The sound itself is.
I'm talking about this guy. I want to know from Duckface, not you.
Yeah, we're not speaking about the same sound though. I like to listen to like.
But we're talking about the same idea.
Do you like the association? Like the sound is killing somebody, or sound is causing suffering, sound is death, or are you just like the actual sound itself?
The sound itself.
So you like a loud, sharp pop?
Yeah, exactly. Like when it breaks, like the sound barrier. Like when the bullet travels for a certain speed, it will break the sound barrier.
Right. Okay. So you like the crack, but
the crack. Yeah, exactly.
Okay. So you listen to the crack, but why? I don't.
Because you say it. Because I want to talk about why I listen to that sound.
I think that's what why I don't listen to Megadeth and shit like that, because I feel like I should listen to Megadeth because I'm so lonely and I don't hang out with people and
listen to that sound?
Why would you think of Megadeth would alleviate that?
Why do you listen to that sound of the gun pop? Because I think it's similar to the reason why I listen to the sound of the tank boom.
I just like how it sounds like.
Can you go find an example while Pretender talks about his gun sound?
I'll show you my example.
And by the way, I'm going to play this while you're waiting. This is my sad wrist-cutting song.
Okay, here. I already found it, so don't bother.
All right.
Share screen. Share.
Do I have to be shared? Can't you just play it?
Yeah. No. Here. How are you going to hear it?
You just play it.
Yeah, that's what I'm doing.
Yeah, but why are you just playing? Okay, stop. Okay, you're watching a video, so I can understand you being stimulated by what's going on in the video, but the actual sound itself is like, what are you talking about? It's just
this is the part that's difficult for me to explain, because I think the reason why I like the sound so much is because I saw a person reviewing the game, and when he was reviewing the game, he said, listen, this is the Baneblade. If those 11 guns don't sell it to you, I'll let them speak for themselves. Like, because he couched it as so cool, I think the sound is cool.
Why don't you say you like the guy, therefore you like what he likes. That makes more sense than you actually just like an ambient noise that's of a gun.
I do like the noise itself too, because I'm like, this is a really powerful sounding gun, and I imagine if this tank, this 300 plus ton tank existed in real life,
how long can you listen to a tank shooting?
A few minutes. Because I'm not really listening
to the tank. You know what I like? I like the sound of my dog sleeping. But I can't put on a tape of him sleeping and go, gee, this is so nice to listen. I'm like,
for me, it's not an emotional sound.
I heard it. I'm done with it. It's not like
when I listen
to the imagination. It's the imagination. That's what it is. It's the imagination. It's like me imagining myself impressing a bunch of people with the power of this cannon.
Okay, so I can understand that. You like the emotional association of boom, it's a powerful thing, I'm a powerful person. I can understand that.
Yeah, that's what I like. I love that.
Okay.
I can't express it naturally, so I just express it in my head. And so, if I was just watch the video itself and just focus on the video, it'd be boring as fuck. But because I can think about it and put all these scenarios in there, that's why I like it.
That makes sense. All right, now we got to the why part. All right, Duckface, what were you gonna say?
Well, you said before, you said that. You think of me when you think of me. You think that I should listen to Megadeth or something.
The people who are silent. Have the violent music because it's like they hide and suppress everything, so everything's like a pressure cooker inside. That's why they have such all the anger that's bottled up in them. That's why they release it, is listening to music that is reflective of that.
Yeah, but I don't listen to music like that. I listen to
Well, you're not necessarily the person I would talk about, because right now you're talking a lot. You would talk more than I would expect Brick to listen to that more than you. You are able to express yourself when you're prompted, at least. Whereas Brick is
okay. I get you. Because I listen to chick music. I listen to what chicks listen to.
Yes, I do the same thing. I do the same thing, Duckface.
See, this is the thing I don't get. I mean, actually, maybe I do get it.
I was trying to come up with something. Like, I was like, I don't listen to Megan. What do I listen to that is dark?
I like to not listen to chick music ideally. Like, why should I listen to it? That's like a faggot thing. But then I realized there are chick songs that I actually like. Like, this one song, because it's with this Wes Anderson movie, it's called Nico. Here, I actually like this one here.
Let me play this one. Oh, is it these days?
Yeah, I watch it with video, which is like fucking amazing. Hold on, let me find it.
I like some Justin Bieber music occasionally. I hate admitting it, but I do like it. Some of the songs are legit.
Me too, especially the new ones.
I haven't heard the new one. I might have to go on the Justin Bieber fever after this class.
Yeah, I learned this on the guitar. I like it so much.
Amazing.
I don't like how she sings though. I don't like her voice. She's not like.
I fucking love this song!
I don't do too much talking.
I'll tell you where it gets real, hold on.
I would repeat the guitar. I would put the guitar.
Professor Shadow's face back and over is better.
These days I seem to think a lot about the things that I forgot to do.
Aw, that's all ruined right here. That's the part where it gets ruined. Do, and then it's the orchestration, but the first part with the guitar, I mean, it's so something so soothing about a sad emo faggot guitar. Okay, here. You didn't like Yesterday, Pretender. Here's my emo song. Let's see how you like this one. Where is my
Shadow Scream, Professor?
Why?
Because it's the quality of sound is better. We can hear
we'll
it.
We'll hear it double. That's the problem. Don't share it.
No, we're not.
Because we'll hear it from the speakers and we'll hear it from my
speaker. No. He will pick. There's a button to tick share the computer sound.
I forgot. Listen, your opinion is not relevant to me because you don't commit to your belief, so I'm going to ignore you right now.
No, but I can still talk while I'm sharing.
I know, but shh.
Goldenrod and the 4-H stone, the things I brought you when I found out.
God, it's a fucking
horrible. I don't like this sad music, dude, because it just like, okay, you know what, I can appreciate it because you like it, but this is not something I would ever listen to on my own. I would never seek out a song like this.
Yeah,
ever.
And you know what, I realize like the music is reflective of your experience, and because we have different experiences, we're going to gravitate towards different things that mirror our experiences. So this mirrors my life experience, like the sound of it, not the words. I don't even know what the words are. Like a lot of times when they sing, I hope the words are, I hope they make sense when I read them on the paper, but I actually hope they're vague enough that I can apply my own meaning to them when I'm singing them. So I don't even know what the words are on like most of the songs I listen to. I don't know what the words mean, and I don't know even if the words are clear. Like there's famous videos of like famous songs where people sing them and they miss sing the words because they don't even know the words sound weird when you're singing because you don't even know what they are. That's exactly how my experience of most of my music is I don't know what the words are singing. And if I really like the sound, the whole overall sound of the song, then I might be motivated to investigate. Otherwise, I just like, I'm perfectly fine never looking up the lyrics and just inventing my own lyrics or just enjoying the ambiance of what I think the lyrics mean. So
I love to do that. That's why I like so many ambiance like music, like video game soundtracks and shit like that.
Yeah, but they don't have lyrics.
Yeah, they're not trying to direct me to something. Like,
yeah, but
like,
I like the lyrics. I don't like ambient music unless I'm just like blazed or doing something. Like if I'm playing Slither, I'll listen to Bach or something ambient that has no lyrics. Or actually, that's not true. I'll still listen to like Iron and Wine, but I listen to like a certain sound. Like I can't listen to or rap music while I'm playing Slither. It's fucking noise. It has to be something like backgroundish that can fade into the background and not distract me from what I'm doing. It has to like complement what I'm doing. So I think the music is personal in that if you go through life with certain experiences, like you have a happy life, you'll listen to more happy music. If you have a sad life, you're gonna listen to more sad music. I have a sad life, so I think it's reflective in my emo choices. But that's not all, and that's not like totally the sum of my life, because I do have, you know, fun times where I listen to MOP, Anti Up, which I love.
Things like that.
So I can definitely get into different moods. But overall, it's like my life mood is reflective of my major experiences. And so that's like I can appreciate segments of my experience of my life where I'm having fun with friends. But the majority of my life is this type of like emo crap music.
See, the thing that defines my life is not really like sadness. My thing that defines my life is the need or the desire for recognition and to prove myself.
What makes sense where you listen to like iconic, like epic type music. Dun, 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 like I'm going to accomplish something.
Dramatic music. Because I haven't yet gotten to a point where I'm like, what's the point of accomplishing things? I'm still like, I still have the good intentions where I want to be the guy who beats the odds and fucking gets the girl and not get the girl, but accomplishes something that people in a wide sphere like. Because I don't yet see, because I think
you're still, you're like that conqueror, not Napoleon. Who's the other guy who I'm thinking of? There's like a famous guy in history.
Columbus.
No.
Genghis Khan?
No, a conqueror. He's like, oh, fuck.
Napoleon.
No, one of our
critics. What kind of conqueror?
Oh, it's like one word.
Alexander the Great?
Alexander or something like, no, it's one of those guys who's famous. Hannibal.
Hannibal, yeah.
What's his name? Hannibal the something.
He did something with elephants. Yeah, something with elephants. I know about Hannibal. One of the things I used to do was I used to look up the top military leaders of all time, and it was like Alexander the Great, Genghis Khan, and I just look at their lives, and I'm like, how can I mimic this into my own life? Because it's like, I don't want to just, because the thing is, I don't know how to get validation in a healthy way, so I feel like the proper way to get validation is to do something grand, so that you have no choice but to give me validation, whether I'm a good person or not.
Most people, that's why they idolize Jordan. They're, you know, top, the cream of the crop, the highest, highly skilled, the one who gets the adulation and the fans and the worship.
It's so bizarre. I wouldn't say bizarre, but it seems like almost too good to be true. That just, if you just say what you believe, why you believe it, and you're committed to it.
No one has to bother to become the best in the world.
Yeah, it's like, that. It's not just that. The validation I'll get from that will be enough. Because for me, I'm so starved of it.
Well, because when you're starved, it's just like when you go out to eat, you want a buffet. You don't want a meal. Yeah. You want everything. But when you become practical you're satiated, you realize your stomach is only a certain size, and you can't even if you want a buffet, you can't physically fit it. Just like with adulation. Like, it's not even practical to be a superstar, because it's nice to see Jordan. But if you had to practically live his life and you could never go outside without hundreds of people just mobbing you for an autograph and just stopping you as you're walking, it would be totally impractical to even live. But to have, like, people in your immediate community, like just your friends and family and people, your neighbors, like you and want to hang out with you, that would be good enough for you. You just don't have it. So you start fantasizing about the entire world giving it to you when really you only require just people around you.
The entire world. You just summed up my life, wanting the entire world to fucking pay attention to me. Holy shit. Fuck, dude.
That's how you get out of that's. But that's exactly what happens when you're starved, when your necessity is not met. You obsess over it. It just takes, like, unnatural proportions in your life. Whether really, like, you should just eat, you know, as much as your stomach can fit. As much as you require for nutrition. Duckface, stop being committed to my belief. If you have a fucking view, fight to say it. Stop passively deferring to me just because I lead the class. Doesn't mean your view isn't as valid. It just means you just are not willing to say it.
What's your view, Duckface?
You don't have to compete to play basketball. What I was gonna say.
Yes.
Like in snowboarding. Yeah, I was thinking like in snowboarding, you can go to the Olympics or you can go like free riding.
Yeah.
Like I love watching like that. I'm gonna fucking show you something.
You're right. I like, you know, when I play basketball, it's usually competing to win the game and get the adulation that way. But I actually like more playing with your friends and you fuck around with them. It's like, it's not about the score at that point. It's just about like teasing. I love nothing more than playing like. When I was in high school, I'd play one-on-one with my friend, and we just fuck around. He's like a short little goop kid, and I was just like, I'd have fun, not score, but just also, like fuck around also, and talking to while I'm playing.
It's even better also, like when you watch snowboarding in the free, like wild snowboarders, they do like 10,000 more complicated tricks. And,
yeah, because nothing, the pressure isn't on the line to like get the score.
No,
you don't have
either.
To be conservative with your move. You could just be like, I'm going to try the craziest shit ever.
Yeah, in competitions, there's like a ton of regulations that like you can't do this dangerous thing because then others gonna see it and they're gonna try it.
Yeah, try
so you
it.
Have to like stifle yourself. But if you watch like a wild dude, in the wild,
a snowboarder in the wild.
Yeah, a deer in the wild sounds like
fucking. We're seeing a snowboarder in the wild right now. He's playing a psycho sick move.
Yeah, but that they do like fucking crazy. I can watch those things like every. I want to show you a clip of this fucking crazy. They do like. 20 spins and shit.
All right, while you're doing that, let's get back to his next choice for Mr. Wallpaper over here.
Fuck.
Bunny Boy.
Obada ni toma.
This was the pre-internet era when you could
download. Hold on, let me turn it down. Go ahead,
girl that I liked gave me this CD.
Speak up a little bit.
I said the girl that I liked gave me this CD, and I really liked the CD, and I really liked the girl, and I liked the CD
even
more.
I don't think you like the CD. I think you like the girl, and therefore, whatever she likes, you like. So if she liked a bowl of shit, you would like a bowl of shit.
Maybe. But I never told her I liked
her,
so.
So this is your favorite choice? If you had a choice and you didn't like this girl, you didn't know this girl, this would be your choice of music?
Well, yeah, because I have a similar choice. Guano Apes is the band that's similar to this band, and no one likes it besides me. So I like this kind of band, which is rock and roll, and it has a punch, but it also has a melody, so you can listen to it. It has lyrics that make sense. Actually, the lyrics are really good. You cannot understand them because they're not in English. The lyrics are really good. And the music is really good.
Bonnie boy, you need to commit to your belief, dude. I'm just posting another song that I like in my fucking list because you're like background noise to me. Because you're just so committed to it. You sound so like you're talking about something that's so full of life, but you're so lifeless. You do such a disservice to music because of the way you...
And it doesn't help that I hate this song. I hate music like this. It's like so Coldplay-ish, like... Da-na-na, we're creating an epic song, it's Kubra. It's like, fuck, it's so formulaic.
I don't like Coldplay. I don't feel it as...
This is such a played-out theme in America. I don't know what kind of backwards hick country music you get in Serbia, but this is like so played out here. It's like a... Yo, bro, the drum, especially like bare sparse drums. Like, I've been exposed to so many like versions of drumming that now I hate when dudes are just like four tempo, like dun 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 dun. Like, you hear the dude, like, I hear the definite smack of the drum. I just think like I'm in a fucking high school talent show.
Well, I still like the song.
I mean, listen, when I hear this shit, how can I go back to your drum when I hear this? When I hear this, like, let me give an example. Oh, here we go. Almost has like the epic quality that reminds me of Pretender. Like, this is Pretender, like, struggling to overcome. Here it comes! Get ready! First Pretender, he's gonna miss a good part! Oh, he missed the epic part! Hold on, I gotta get Pretender here for the epic part!